Hello, I'm Tim Rogers. You are watching Kotaku.com. Today I'm playing Judge Eyes by Sega's Ryuga Gotoku Studio. It's out now in Japan. It came out last month, actually, in December of 2018. It doesn't come out in the US until later this year. However, I've got it. I bought it on the PSN, just like a regular schlub. So all you have to do is open a Japanese PSN account, which I've had for, well, ever since I had a PlayStation 3, I've had a Japanese PSN account. So my buddy Kyle sent me a PlayStation point card, because my American credit card doesn't work on there. So thanks, Kyle, for sending me the point card number. That's Takuya Kimura. Takuya Kimura, the Tom Cruise or the Brad Pitt of Japan. This says don't exhibit the game in public. This says it's got flashes, warning, photosensitivity warning. This disclaims that the game is a work of fiction. Ryuga Gotoku Studio. Ryuga Gotoku is not Japanese for Yakuza. It's Japanese for Like a Dragon, which is what the Yakuza games are called. I like this title screen with this multicolored smoke. This is a fantastic title screen. I just have to say, the Japanese name of the game is Judge Eyes, Shinigami no Yuigon, Judge Eyes, the Grim Reaper's Testament, which is a kind of a wild title. And as our hero here enjoys a cigarette, I enjoy some coffee. Oh man. It's decaf coffee. I put some cinnamon in there. Let's go ahead and let's get started. We'll see. I've loaded. I can play a two-player match minigame if I wanted to be really bored. There's three types of games that two players can compete at. Tanoshimi itadakimasu. Two players can partake of enjoyment. To break apart the etymology there. I'm going to try to translate this game as I play. Like I said, I played a little bit yesterday, so today I might be a little bit warmed up, have more notion of the details. We're just going to start a new game. And so there's a mode called Extra Easy, which has a Battle Kantan Nyūryoku, which is the battles are simpler. Just the square button is the only button that is used in battle for Extra Easy mode. And you know what? I'm a hardcore sort of guy. I've beaten the game God Hand on, you know, consistently on level die, which is the hardest difficulty, achieved only by fighting real hard, real fast. I think the Extra Easy mode is great because it lets you enjoy the game like you're watching TV, but we're going to put it on normal because I don't want it to be too easy. And then, you know, am I the only person who just really doesn't know what to ever do with these? I assume every time you ever post a video of a video game that you've captured on the internet, somebody in the comments is going to say, oh, I can't see it so well, or, oh, the sound isn't so good. I'm just going to go ahead and leave it right in the middle. I can sort of see that logo on the right, the scales. And is it just me, or see the drop shadow up there on the game sette akarusa no chose, game settings, brightness adjustment? That drop shadow is like a full font width. I think that's a mistake. I think they made a mistake with that drop shadow distance. It's way too far. We're just going to go ahead and put it in the middle there. That's good. Autosave. Do I want to turn autosave on? Yeah. All right. Save shitemasu. Dengen wo kiranai de kudasai. Please don't turn the power off while the game is saving. It says don't turn the game off when you see the autosave icon. I got to say, have you noticed how long it takes to turn a goddamn video game console off now? You got to hold this little button down for like 10-12 seconds before it turns off. It's like, I kind of see the auto-saving icon as like a dare. It's like, can you run across the room and jam your finger onto that button and hold it down? Can you have the console shut down before the loading or saving finishes? I don't think you could. So, we're going to see. Maybe just don't yank the plug out while that's happening. And then you yank the plug out and then the PlayStation gets all snippy and passive aggressive with you when you turn it back on. It's like you didn't shut it down correctly. I swear, every time I move this PlayStation 4 Pro from the office into the recording room, it tells me I didn't shut it down correctly the last time, which is just it's just one of those things. I mean, this loading time is long enough probably to shut the console down properly during it. I'm running out of stuff to say. I need video game noise. Oh, there we go. That kind of cup right there is called a you know me. You meaning a hot liquid, and nomi being the stem form of the verb to drink. Oh, it says Genta. Genta Law Office. They're right next to a... They've got like a girls club sign there. This right here is Mr. Genta. Mr. Genta is the head lawyer of the Genta Law Office. Ben Goshi, he's a lawyer. It's those three kanji at the end of his title up there. Somebody's asking about Yagami. Yagami is our guy right here. Our boy right here with his hair slicked back. You can tell he's a proper lawyer. And they're saying, he says, Yagami's real busy lately. Everybody wants Yagami. They all want him. He's a lawyer employed at the Genta Law Office. Yagami Takayuki. And this guy's like, how long is this Yagami guy going to be popular, man? Right, Saori-chan? How long do you think it's going to be? He says. This is Saori-chan. He called her Chan. I'm not going to call her Chan because that's diminutive. She's a lawyer herself. So we're just going to go ahead and call her Saori-san. And she was also fielding a phone call about Yagami. This jealous guy's like, everybody wants Yagami. Shintani. Shintani's this guy. He's your senpai. Slightly older than you. Slightly cooler than you. Tougher looking, for a certain. He's saying my... So basically, he's jealous of him because he got a not guilty verdict. There was a man accused of a murder. And he got him off as not guilty. And he's saying everybody wants the lawyer that got a guy off. He's pointing out that Yagami used to be a punk, a gorotsuki. He used to just be a some sort of street tough. Now he's a lawyer. He said that his getting a not guilty verdict was a magure, like a fluke. And this guy resents him for having received such a fluke, because even though it's a fluke, he's pointing out that 99% of trials in Japan go to a guilty verdict. The accused are convicted 99% of the time in Japan. That's actually a fact of the Japanese law system. And these characters are going to point it out for several hours, the first several hours of the game. Now, Shintani's saying, oh, you should be more respectful to your senpai. I'm your senpai. Now, he's saying, oh, maybe you could choose Shintani. They just keep getting phone calls. People want Yagami because he's a famous lawyer. Such a fluke. He is the 1%. Now, he points out, Yuzai-ritsu wa 99.9%. He says that the guilty percentage is 99.9%. So he added a 0.9%. I don't know if that was embellishment on his part talking to a client, but it is actually more like 99%. It's like 1 in 100 gets off as not guilty. And Saori-san just got mad. She was telling me to be quiet. She's saying, are you sure? Wakarimashita. I see. It's Taimas. I will tell them. Or him. And he's like, what? Oh, we got somebody calling for Yagami. He's like, oh, of course. And the client is Okubo Shinpei. He's like, what? Okubo Shinpei? The guy that Yagami got off not guilty? And it's a murder. And then he says, but that murder was already... No, it's different from the previous one. Just recently, just a minute ago, Okubo stabbed his lover, and then with gasoline. And he says, no, ake ne daro, which is a handy phrase to... It means, is not the case, yeah? Koibito wa sasta. He stabbed his lover, Okubo Shinpei? That kind of... Why was it? And then look at this grisly image that we start the game with. Just the grisly image of a house burning down. You could not conjure a grislier image with a photograph full of bears. Blood on the knife. Blood on the pants. House burns down. Blood on the photograph. I mean, we're just talking. It's just dark stuff. That's Okubo Shinpei. picked up on murder with a bloody t-shirt, wearing his pajamas, a pair that looks like Birkenstocks. Everybody get out of the way, we're bringing a murderer through here. House isn't just on fire, it's blowing up. Something strikes him, his eyes. The photograph explodes. Now, right as it touches the ground, watch this. I like this touch. Right here, here it comes. Here it comes. Oh, quick cut to black. On that day, my lawyer self was killed alongside Emi-chan by the serial killing murderer, Okubo Shinpei, at the hands of the serial killer. If we were translating this formally, we might have a little more fun. Sanengo, three years later, December 10th, 2018, Tokyo, Kamurocho. If you've played Yakuza, you've hung out here in Kamurocho. Possibly you've hung out here a lot. If you've played half of one Yakuza game, you've hung out here a lot. If you've played more than one, you've hung out here too much. And let me tell you, I can't get more than too much. I mean, no. I can't get less than too much of this town. He's turned into a guy who doesn't own a razor anymore. He's no longer a lawyer. His partner is telling him over the Bluetooth, I'm near Donkey. Donkey is short for Don Quixote. Do you see the Yaro? He says. This is our boy Kaito. Kaito's your partner. He wears a cool shirt. He's a flashy dresser. And there's the guy we're following. He doesn't notice us at all. He says, you're pretty good at following people. And he's like, hey, I've got some kind of talent. And then he's like, well, that might be saying too much. You gotta admit, this is pretty interesting. A detective? Following a detective? Or tracking a detective? You don't even see this sort of thing in a TV drama, he says, which is referencing the fact that this game resembles TV drama. There's our guy. He's just got a... just like the courteous sort of street man, because he keeps his garbage in paper bags. He's like, I'll follow you from here. Oh, these guys, they just called him Osan. I mean, like, stupid old guy, old punk. Our first indicator, as if we needed one, that our main character's a guy like in his 40s. Nandateme ora. Do you want to die? Are you stupid? Hey, what are you doing back there, Tabo? They call him Tabo. Oh, I've been, I'm being annoyed by some Chinpira. He says, he calls him Chinpira. And he says, Chinpira te dare no koto da? Who are you calling a Chinpira? We need not translate Chinpira. Just know that Chinpira is a word that guys who are Chinpira don't want to be called. And he's like, I'll be right there in a minute after I finish my business, and his business is punching, and business is good. Gets into his drunken boxing stance here. Is this guy for real? Do a little bit of a Bruce Lee, come get some. Get thrift store kid you here. Acho, acho. That's a kung fu sound. You gonna kung fu us to death, buddy? This yaro, kono yaro. Joto Janika. Oh, we got us a real cool guy here, basically, is what he said. Again, please don't consider my off-the-cuff translations to be anything resembling what I would do in a formal capacity were I doing this professionally. I gotta save the good stuff for when I am doing translation professionally. I might be translating a video game right now, actually. I just did a combo. Oh, what are we doing? So it's going to tell me how to defend. Defend with the L1 button. Give me that L1 button, punk. I actually did not properly defend that. I let go. I got impatient. I just want to beat these guys up, but in order to traverse the tutorial, I must follow what they're telling me to do. Okay, so I can actually hold this, and I can track a guy, follow him. Pretty good. Lock on. R1 is your lock on. I wish it was a toggle lock. Maybe there is one optional available. This kid to you guys gotta go. Okay, so I can dodge by doing this. Oh, echo! I got grabbed. There we go, okay. I just want to own these guys. Circles. Circles will give me my... You know what circles do if you play the Yakuza. You just get this guy. Grab him with the circle button. Own him. Oh, excuse me? So when you're hitting him, your EX gauge fills up. Press the triangle button to do your heat actions, your X attacks, your big boy mode, as I call it. You want some? Kick him. I love his fighting style. I love it. Because he's just got that kind of flowery style. fans of Virtua Fighter will liken him to Lion or Leon, one of my favorite characters in that game. Got kind of a similar crane style. These guys don't die. Wait, no, what? Hold on. Oh, I need to. What? Okay, there we go. I just really pulverized that guy with a goddamn traffic cone. I really love this drunken boxing throw he does. Just all back. I love it. Oh, wait, hold on. I want to EX action that guy. EX him. Any sort of a... Come on over here. A little bit of Tokyo Street geometry is all you need to execute. I want to insinuate him toward this. Hold on. No. Put him down. Aw, man. Well, I finished that battle in the least spectacular mode possible. I really wanted to get him up against that inscrutable Tokyo Street box. Slam his head into some steel. Oh, here we go. With his fingerless glove, he removes his outfit with one fell grab. Look at the hems on the jeans. Low socks. Wearing some sort of brandless Keds, chain wallet. Fine leather jacket. Shaved in the process of removing his coat and hat. Kaido-san. All right, I'm done. Kaido-san, where are you at? He says I'm on Pink Dori. Uramichi, I'm on a back street near Pink Dori. Pink Avenue. Look at those little brandless Keds he's wearing. He's like, this guy's gonna notice me pretty soon. We don't want the guy to notice us because that's kind of goes against being a detective. Nen no tame mappu. I should look at the map just to make sure. Like, I feel like that's a little bit lacking in Ring of Truth. Like, he wouldn't need to look at the map. Anybody who's been around Kabukicho, you generally just know where stuff is. This is Showa Dori, which is a real road in Tokyo. The rest of this is all made up. Yeah, this is Nakamichi. Nakamichi is usually what they call a road that is in the middle. It means Main Street. It means middle road. Nakamichi Dori means middle road street or avenue. These are all just general street names, and in Japan you don't really have names. I can set a little waypoint marker. Let's do that. We're gonna strut down there. Oh, it's gonna immediately, it lets me take 3 steps before it tells me how to dash. I know how to dash. Thing is, I like to walk slow because I like to really feel like I'm here. Net Cafe. 100 yen. And 3 hours for 7. So notice this. 100 yen for... Don't bump into me, man. I like his briefcase, though. It's a 2-way bag. It's got a handle and it's got a... like a shoulder strap. Is he just going to stand behind me? Am I blocking your pathfinding? Just get out of here, buddy. Notice it says 1 hour, 100 yen. 3 hours, 700 yen. It's an interesting factoid there. Because it's not actually 1 hour for 100 yen. It's 1 hour for 300 yen. They hit you with like a $200... $200 yen an hour desk charge. He says he's on to my tail. And then he's like, I gotta cool off, I gotta step back. He's like, hurry up. You're the one who's good at finding these guys. If we lose him, it's your fault. And he's like, what? You're the one who already sort of lost him. So my buddy Kaito has stepped back for fear of being outed. What's that like? Look at that big old bag. That's a big backpack hanging low, buddy. Tighten those straps. You know what? As I've gotten older, I have no qualms about tightening my backpack straps. You can still look legit. You can still look like you're not a loser. I mean, maybe I do look like a loser. So, okay, I love this. He's got to look for the guy, right? So he's like, I got to find this guy. Let's take one look at him. He's wearing a hat. He's got a special black mole above his left eyebrow. Let's take a look if we can find him. And so now, in order to begin the tailing sequence, I need to... And first of all, I love how this game has these little... It has a little mini-game-esque game mechanical challenge, quote-unquote challenge, for every one of the elements of following and tailing a person, we're going to go ahead and... So it's explaining to me how you're supposed to use the cursor, find the guy, and then figure out which... if he meets all the criteria. So, hilariously, we're looking for a guy who's wearing a hat, and he's got a jacket, right? And he's got, what do you call it? He has a certain type of eye. Wide-set eyes. He's got a little bit of a mustache going on and a tiny little beard, and he has a mole. So there's two guys who each have a hat and a jacket we can see from far away. I find this just really precious. So look at this guy. So I can investigate this guy. I know that's not the guy. I know this is clearly our guy. That's definitely our guy. But let's see what happens if I look at this guy. I looked at the right guy first last time. Oh, where's the mole? I don't see the mole, he says. Koitsu janai. Not this guy. And then hilariously, can I investigate this guy as well? This is definitely not the guy. He doesn't have the beard. I've already blown my perfect score. Okay. He's got the hat. He's got the jacket. He's got the wide-set eyes. He's got the he's got the little dirty ratty beard. Rei no tanteda. Rei means example. Rei no tante, the detective of our example, or the detective in question. I only scored 10 SP. If I would have gone straight for him, I would have gotten 20. Oh well. Oh well. SP is used to buy abilities and such. So I'm already at a little bit of a disadvantage here. I wonder if there's a true ending that requires you to get all this stuff. I was just thinking, having played the first 3 hours or so of this game. Okay, so now is the tailing segment. You gotta tail the guy. This is a good little vertical slice of this game because it's, well, it's gonna tutorialize me into hiding behind this sign. The target's gonna see me. I was just thinking that if Yakuza, after playing about 3 hours, I'm feeling like if Yakuza games are Final Fantasy, this kind of has like a Persona thing going on, where it has all these little itemized segments. So I've hidden. That's his suspicion meter up there. If it reaches max, I fail. So I press circle to jump into cover. I gotta say, this guy, if he's also a detective, he's kind of not very good at it. It's going to immediately start playing this Metal Gear Solid music. Okay, I'm hiding behind a red lantern. Clearly, he will not see me here. Is he going to turn? No, we're going to jump to the next cover. Oh my god. Chill out, Mom. Telling me I've got 20 seconds before I lose him forever. I love seeing these street fashions here. They're all pretty in line with what I remember of Kabukicho. I'm going to tell you what, Kabukicho was exactly the same the first time I went there in 2001 and the last time I went there in 2010 when I ended up lived in Tokyo for about 10 years. I was often in Kabukicho. Chotto anta. Soro soro tamatta yachin. Okay, I actually meant to translate that into English instead of instead of just repeating the Japanese. I will tell you, if you want to learn Japanese, that's what I did. I watched TV dramas and just repeated every word that everybody said, and eventually I could get a job at a Japanese office and answer the phone and speak Japanese, and then they wouldn't actually know that I wasn't a Japanese person. It's not actually that hard. I'm an idiot. If I can do it, you can do it. Basically, that was his landlord saying, pretty soon you're going to have to pay off that whole bunch of rent that's just piling up, buddy. And he's like, please, just give me one more week. And she goes, this ain't going to happen again, pal. Oh no, this man has blocked my vision. I just really don't want the electro shock of that music to start playing again. And I hide behind this group of people. Check this out. Press circle to pretend to look at your phone. I'm gonna exit my cover. Don't let him round the corner. Don't let him round the corner. So I just need to get somewhere that he can see me. He can't see me. He's over there at a vending machine. Or as I like to call them, Vendos. He's over at a Vendo. A Jidol Hanbaiki, as they're called in Japan. Hanbai means to sell. It means buy, sell. Ki means machine. Hanbaiki means selling machine. Jidol means automatic. Jidol Hanbaiki means vending machine. If you're a tough dude and you like to talk in slang, or you just don't have a hold... I've not lost him. I see him. I see him with my goddarn eyes. Kentucky Akimura from Japan's favorite boys smap, not see, over a low wall. If you speak in slang, you'd call a vending machine a jihanki. He says the detective is on champion guy. Guy means street, so champion guy sounds like he's saying champion guy. But it's champion street. He's like, shall we unleash the hato, the dove, the pigeon? They're talking about the drones. He called them to standba, which is a contraction of the word standby. Standby. Standba. He says, don't go wild with the goddarn drone and break it, he tells him. Kaito is, you can tell looking at him that he's just a big, tough dude. And he has a tendency to just go wild. Whether he's, you know, going wild just in general, or probably, you know, using a machine or a device. Don't run too fast. Okay, I got him still in my sights. That's good. Oh, wow. How theatrical, how dramatic. Shout me out in the comments if your favorite part of Metal Gear Solid 4 was the part where you're following the guy around the misty European metropolis. Oh, come on. I feel like that music could, it just kind of comes in with just no ability whatsoever to hang out. Tailing complete. Good work, detective. Do you feel like a detective yet? Because I do. I got 80 special points for that, skill points. The detective has stopped in a vacant lot in Champion Guy. I shouldn't go get him. Need to make sure he doesn't see us yet. Got to make sure we know who he's meeting. He seems like he's going to be meeting somebody. He's in a place where only people who don't want to be seen by other people go. So I love this part. He's like, I've launched the drone. Can you see it? And he's like, oh, can you wait just a moment? So now we get the... this is an active search mode, they call it. So I'm looking for something. Basically, this is to teach me the mechanic of looking for something. I find this kind of silly. Because... oh, hold on, there's a cat just kind of sitting on this machine over here. I can investigate the cat. The drone is up here. You know, so we got the guy over here. Right? He's like, what is he doing in a place like this? So, I mean, I'm supposed to look for the... oh, wait, hold on. I get skill points just for looking at even useless stuff. Oh, that's... this is not the drone. It is a cat. Didn't get any skill points for that. The drone is up here. I don't know why it's important for me to look at the drone and go, oh, I see it. Okay, mitsuketa. He's like, okay, I found it. He's like, sumaho does it. Sumaho. Sumaho is short for, sumato... smarto home. Smartphone. Sumaho. Smartphone. It's a little word to remember. Go ahead and call your smartphone, your smaho, if you want. If you need a Japanese word to impress your friends. He's like, have you been practicing using this thing? You're getting good at it. And he's like, don't talk to me right now. I'm working. He needs to concentrate in order to fly the drone because he's such a meathead, beef-handed man. He's like, he's meeting somebody. Oh, we're right. He was here to meet somebody. It turns out. I've seen this guy somewhere before. I think he works at the off-track betting bar. Bar. So this guy is spending a whole bunch of money even though he owes a bunch of people some money. So why is he meeting this bar guy here? in such a secluded place on purpose. What was our mission again? Shakin Toritate. So, debt collection. They're here to do a debt collection. If we're going to jump and get him, we should get him now. Let's go get him. Tabo. Calls him Tabo. I love that he calls him Tabo. So now, basically, you just want to run in here like a chump. Did I get points for that? I got 0 yens, but I got 80 SP. He's got a big old pile of Fukuzawas. Fukuzawa Yukichi is the man who appears on the 10,000 yen bill. It's like, how you doing, Mr. Detective? What? The service at the bars here in Kamurocho is pretty good, huh? Oh yeah, something about you, buy one, if you lose horse racing, if you've bought more than a certain number of tickets, you get another ticket back. Hey, where are you going, man? Aren't you going to get the money from the guy who's here to pay you some money? He's like, what do you want? A customer of our customer wants some money, wants you to give him back some money. He's like, oh, so you're just some debt-collecting chinpira. Oh, you found me. Good work finding me. You call me a chinpira? No. I'm actually just like you. Oh, so you're saying you're a detective. Tante, they keep calling each other Tante, but it's got more meanings than just detective. I mean, it means detective. He's like, anyway, I've got a job. I got to talk to you here. We've got you on tape, pal. So now you can't run. You're going to pay us the money, chump. He's like, yeah, I got it. I got the money. But, I'll give it back to you once I win a bunch of money on horses. So just wait. And he's like, are you serious? I love the word zuzushi. It just means kind of like a, kind of a grandiose, dumb, sort of imaginary, daydreaming, pipe dreamy thing. He ran away. Yeah, I see. He ran away. He's like, he ran away. Oh, he had a road flare. By the way, don't ever stare at a road flare if you're holding it in your hand. You can get like a, dry your eyeballs out. You'll get a migraine. Oh my god, I love how it's giving me a tutorial to tell me to use the left stick to run. Okay, so basically I have to use, so there's a couple little minor QTEs here. They're pretty easy. I love this music. This like real kind of, oh, Final Fantasy sound and tunes. If you press the wrong button, he just totally dies. Oh my god, I almost lost it there. Oh my god, I vaulted over that idiot. God, I love this. Anyone who's ever run desperately down the streets of Kabukicho before will find this quite a nostalgic experience. Running away from the cops, running toward a dude. We've all done it. I'm just joking. I've never actually been in a fight with anybody in Kabukicho before. Okay, we got him. I like how immediately after the tutorial ended, I was just hammering the button it told me to press. I actually performed perfectly on that. If you miss a couple of shots on that chase, you end up with like a lower score. Kono Yaro, he called me this Yaro. Kono means this. So this guy, he doesn't want to give you back the money. He wants to fight. This guy is clearly not, like, first of all, you can tell from the hat he's wearing that he's not as good at fighting as my guy with the chain wallet. Alright, and we're going to learn about the different stances. So this puts me in the man pose, where he's just tougher. I like this music with like the sort of garbled train announcer sounding just guy kind of. It just reminds, it's like a Tekken soundtrack. I'm gonna beat you to death with a garbage can, Moran. Oh my god. He just broke a plastic garbage can. I love them using this these pedestrians as like a wall to keep me in the arena. A good Yakuza series staple. This guy's a real punching bag. Wow, did I just get punked? Hit me. Hit me. Hit me. Oh, I wanted to try to dodge really smoothly, and then I just didn't. His name is Umazuki Tante, detective who likes horses. Particularly, I presume he likes betting on the horses. I'm going to change to my different stance so I can do tougher big boy moves. Okay, hold on. I want to get him with an EX action. How would you like to be beaten to death with this? I wanted to get him in the wall, like up against the wall. I gotta say, nothing says brutality like breaking plastic over somebody, right? Oh, this guy sucks. You can like see how bad his skin is. He's got just like, he like hasn't washed his face in a couple of days. So you said you were a detective, huh? A Tante. Could be a private detective investigator. Oh, you want to exchange business cards? Is that it? He says, kind of like a tough guy. This ain't the time, buddy. Here you go. The name's Yagami. Of the Yagami Detective Office here in Commodore Cho. Takes this. All right, now give me the money. It's 150,000 yen. 15 mon. Mon is 10,000. Oh, you're gonna collect a debt from me? I'm gonna sue you, buddy. Ooh, man. You say you're gonna sue us? How dare you say something like that? What are you trying to say? He's like, hey, Kaito-san, don't beat this guy up. You say you're a Tante? No, you're a Yakuza. He says, shut up. Just give us the money. He's like, if you kill him, that's going to be scary. I get it. All right, I got it, buddy, he's saying. I'm amazed he didn't get blood all over his, like, sweet clothes. Look at that shiny shirt he's wearing. He's handing him the... That's Fukuzawa Yukichi once again. If you take this money, I will definitely sue you. Look, my nose is broken. And he's like, nah, you just have a nosebleed. Also, you hit me first. And he's like, no, you hit me first. I will sue you, and I will definitely... And then he shows him his badge here. His lawyer badge. So, Bengoshi Badge. Your lawyer badge. Are you saying you're not a detective? He's like, what are you going to do? You really want to go toe-to-toe with me? So, I pointed out in a previous video I did that this is like... Reminds me of the Mito Komo in a Japanese TV show where the guy at a certain point in every episode reveals that he's a messenger from the emperor, and a Japanese person on Twitter linked to my video and said, here's a video of a non-Japanese person who knows Mito Komo. And I gotta say, I showed that to my mom and I was like, look, mom, I do know stuff. And she was like, I can't read Japanese. I don't know what that means. That's a joke. I did not actually show it to my mom. I believe this song is by the... There's that lawyer badge once again. He's going to display that lawyer badge a lot. That was Nagoshi Toshihiro's name there. Nagoshi, the mastermind of the Yakuza franchise. So we know two things. Badge and a gun. Lawyer badge and a detective gun. He just threw a cigarette at the camera before turning into smoke. Is this a drug syringe? I don't know. I don't know if there's drugs in this game yet. This is a Hamura Kyohei. I like Hamura. Hamura's a tough Yakuza dude. We're going to meet him in a little bit. Some pills? This game is really showing us a lot of human vices. This dude was in a Yakuza... Or not a Yakuza. He was in some Godzilla movies. Notice this lady does not get her name in the credits. Why not? So I love how much this game makes me think about Alexandros' song called Arpeggio. This game really makes me feel like I'm playing a Japanese TV drama. This guy was also in Godzilla Final Wars, which is a work of art if you haven't seen it. This just so totally reminds me of a Japanese TV drama. Like, it's got like this pitch perfect intro theme song. It's really good. So now he stares at us with his judgmental eyes. Judge Eyes. The English title of this game is Judgment. I don't know. Judge Eyes is pretty good. I thought it was dumb when I first heard it. Now I think Judge Eyes is a really cool name. You call it Judgment, it just sounds... It's just a word. Judge Eyes is like a... It's a trademarkable phrase. So here we are back in Commodore Show. I hope we see that theme song at the beginning of every episode of the game. We probably won't, though. I'm hoping for like a Metal Gear Solid 5 sort of thing. If you would like to enjoy a lively night, Commodore Cho has got you covered. However, the shadows are dark in proportion to the brightness of the neon. Actually, buddy, that's not neon. That's electric lights and LEDs. The biggest Yakuza group, the Tojokai, runs this town. They've got a... There's a whole lot of cool stuff going on in Kamino Cho and a whole lot of crime. But there's also a lot of scary stuff. Just Asobi Hanbun, a half-playful group of young thieves have been cavorting around town. This Oliver Twisty parkour group. The police have yet to catch... He's wearing a Guy Fawkes mask. The police have yet to catch a single one of these young Oliver Twisty and hooligans. A little bit of Dickens in here. Though the biggest story happening in Kamino Show right now is that of a goddamn serial killing. Look at that guy. Dead with sunglasses on. I hope to be like that someday. In the last 3 months, three Yakuza from Kansai, Osaka, have been killed. They're saying that the Tojo clan, who run this town, have done it. And get this. Oh, that guy's getting queasy. The eyes have been dug out of this one as well. No one has found any of the six eyes of the three dead men. I run a detective office in a corner of this town. My big brother style dude, Kaito-san. Yeah, he used to be with the Tojo clan, Yakuza. And me? Well, I'm Yagami Takayuki. 3 years ago, I was a lawyer, but I'm not anymore. The lawyer badge, which I still carry, it's just kind of an accessory, like a decoration. My office is right next to a club, Sega. I go in there and I play Hang-On and Space Harrier sometimes when I'm supposed to be doing other stuff. Let's find out how much fun I can have in between my work stuff. That's how I would perform the character if I were hired to be the voice actor, which I'm not. Chapter 101, Mogura, which means mole. See the zero before the one? Is there going to be more than 10 chapters? The zero was sort of just outline. It wasn't filled in. Maybe not. Yagami Tante Jimusho, private investigator. Cardboard box on top of a bookshelf. Ramen and soba in there. Vintage pinball machine. Vintage pinball sucks. It's not fun. Pinball didn't get fun until like the 70s. That was like a 50s pinball machine. Here's your monthly salary. Sorry, but I'll pay you the rest later. What about your share? Well, this is how much we're giving to the client. And I'll take whatever's left from that. And he's like, I should probably go to Genta-sensei once again. Genta's the lawyer that he used to work for. Oh, that law office, they seem to have a lot of free time these days. Is that old guy? Has he got anything to do over there? Are they getting work? He's like, don't make fun of that old guy. And he's like, oh yeah, you used to work there, huh? You should probably buy him some sort of a souvenir, some sort of gift. He gave him 10,000 yen. Theatrically cried to be like, oh, you're really, I hate to put you in a tight spot with money. Oh, the sweet, smooth music ended. Let's take a look. Hold on. So I'm supposed to go buy him a souvenir. So I want to go to the we got a moment now to just kind of chill out. He told me to go over to the Genta Law Office, or he's talking about going to the Genta Law Office to ask if they have any sort of private investigatorial work that they want somebody to do, which I guess a CD law office, they're not really a CD law office. They're defense lawyers. You don't become a defense lawyer in Japan if you're not comfortable with losing most of your cases, though they do have clients who do pay them money, and basically a defense lawyer is just going to be helping negotiate better sentences with judges. So a defense lawyer, despite losing most of the time, they do actually have work to do, and there is some grading of who's a good lawyer and a bad lawyer. So this lawyer that he's worked for before, he hits them up for investigator work when they need somebody to, for example, gather evidence, which is what we're about to go do. We're going to go talk to his old daddy lawyer, and we're going to gather evidence. So this is a really subtle touch, but anybody who's lived like a hard dude in Japan, which I don't want to say I have, but I had roommates who were hard dudes. You know that this is like a really nice visual, just kind of a subtle tactile touch that he literally has to scoot behind his furniture because everything is just so flush against the walls. And clearly, they want you to notice this and acknowledge this coziness. So first of all, I can see the persistent exterior. You can see people. See, there's a person down there in that window on the right. So I can actually squeeze past and you hear the leather. You hear that? I love that so much. I love that the leather squinches. Let's get some more. Can I get behind my desk? I can't get behind my desk. It won't let me. It won't let me in. Let's do it again. Let's do this one more time. It's brilliant. And I can put on records. You can find records in the town. You can buy them in stores. When you put on a record, it changes the music that plays in your office. They can be found at various places around Kaminocho. Okay. And he says, "Kakerareru rekodo wo motte inai na." I'm not carrying any records. Explain. Well, what the heck? Yeah, any interior. So he's. Oh, you can actually decorate the interior. Yes. Go for it. Okay. You can look around. So I can decorate the interior. I can like grab this and put it away, and then go over here, and I can just open, put it. I can like put it over here. I can rotate it. Hello? How can I not do this? Why can't I put it down? I guess I messed it up somehow. Let's put it in the middle for good luck. And are we done? Yeah, look at that. I don't have any other items to place, though. This little hot water pot for making tea. He's got his little teacups, little spoon by one of them. Oh, there's a little spoon by the other one. It's the same prefab, rotated. You can tell because the spoon is underneath the handle. Little coffee pot. Couple of, I believe, empty beer cans up here. Can I zoom in? I can't do it first person. Look at this behind the sink. You have this is a Japanese tankless water heater. It's a very sophisticated boiler. You see that skinny pipe? The water goes in that skinny pipe. And it's heated literally by a flame. And so you have normal temperature water goes in and then just scalding hot water comes out. So that's a boiler. Ooh. A little bit of pop in on those. Get that cup to come in there. We're not going to obsess over that. It's beautiful. The amount of detail. It has a ring of truth. You have a hot faucet and a cold faucet. And then they have dishes in here. First of all, I know you're a man and all, Mr. Yagami, but you got to do your dishes. It helps to just have one dish. And then you wash that every time. Look at his burner. You'll see that the gas konro, as they call it, is it's just kind of like a detachable sort of camp style. It's got like a canister slot in it to put a gas canister in. A lot of Japanese apartments do not actually come with gas stoves. The ones that do are, I mean, a lot of them do. All the ones I ever lived in, except one, came with a gas stove. One of them we had to actually purchase a separate one. So you actually, this is kind of a nostalgic image for a lot of Japanese dudes will play this game and be like, oh yeah, I remember having a separate gas canister stove on my countertop in my kitchen. So that's like, I guess that's, and then the microwave on top of the refrigerator, again, that's a nostalgic thing. You might remember having lived in an apartment before where there wasn't a lot of room and the microwave was on top of the refrigerator. He actually has a healthy sized refrigerator. And then this room interior clothes dryer, this is a great touch because there's always a sort of a rail to hang things on in one of these stock style apartments. So he's hanging this clothespin clip hanger plastic thing. Probably bought this for like 100 yen at a 100 yen store. You can tell because it always has a gaudy plastic color. So he's got this blue plastic and then all these little clips. And there's an undershirt. And then is that a pair of boxers? It's like, I think it's a dishcloth. So dishcloth, and he hasn't done the dishes. Should do the dishes, buddy. Case files back there. And then we can see the exhaust fan to keep smoke out of the kitchen. So just blow it straight out of the building. All in all, a properly outfitted zone. My buddy here is probably wondering why I'm just hanging around. He follows me with his judgmental eyes. Looks at me. Looks longingly at his friend. Follows me over here. I gotta say, that is the world's longest lasting cigarette. He's just so relaxed. Don't you just want to sit next to him and be embraced by his beautiful biceps and his shiny silk? Look at the tiling on the table. It's almost the exact pattern that was on my countertop in a house I lived in San Leandro, California. Enough of that. Let's go outside. Or should we? Oh, Soya! Tenkaichi. Oh, there's a limited box of dorayaki. Dorayaki is a Japanese pastry treat. He's telling him he should bring a gift. He should bring a gift. So let's get a miyage. We're going to get him a Japanese okashi, Japanese snack. Once I looked at an apartment in Tokyo, in Tawaramachi, and there was the door of the apartment had a glass window, and it was just like clear glass. Can I close this door? Okay, the door's, oh, no, I want you to close the door, not, well, it had a clear glass window, and I went in, and the apartment was beautiful, and then the guy was like, what do you think? And I was like, well, unfortunately, I want to rent an apartment. I don't want to run a detective office. Oh, I got my detective pack. Toughness Z. This is all my. I bought the big boy version of the game. You know, I got the big boy version. I paid all the money for. I got all this stuff. It was my Christmas present to myself. Okay, so yeah, they gave me all this extra stuff. Let's see what's over here. Don't you hate it when a bunch of boxes and a tiny plastic bucket and some books block you from ever knowing what is upstairs in your own building? It's one of these little emergency boxes. You see these on the walls of every apartment building that is up to fire code. It's that really hard plastic red dome will light up in an emergency. We'll see those in probably... Let's see if we see those in more buildings that we go into. This is like your classic 1970s Shinjuku building. Yeah, here's another one in the lobby. There's always a phone with a direct line to the police inside here. It's a Hijo Denwa. It's an emergency telephone. And it has also an emergency konsento. An emergency power outlet is in there. And that's like a police insignia down there. It's all provided by city government. Fuse box in there. I'm pointing all these details out because these little architectural details are interesting and often overlooked. And it's the sort of thing that for me, when I was watching movies as a college student, movies set in like Taiwan or Hong Kong, this sort of thing always interested me to like see these weird, nebulous, urban, civic structures just jutting out of walls and being like, we don't have those where I'm from. I wonder what it's for. And now, you know, you travel around the world a lot and you get to see a lot of those things and you don't always know what they are. And I don't know. I got curious as a young man living in a foreign country, just like what all these things were. Little garbage can for, on the left would probably be bottles and on the right would be cans. So for glass and aluminum. This is there's a lot of brands in Yakuza. There's probably a lot of YouTube videos out there that are like devoted to just telling you which brands in the Yakuza games are real and which are fake. That guy's just looking at his phone. Don't look at your phone while you walk. No matter how good you think you are at looking at your phone while you walk, you're not good at it. So, Asahi is one of the real brands. This is real. They have this, see that brown bottle with the yellow and red label? That's like an energy drink. The Japanese invented energy drinks. It's like a vitamin energy. Up on the upper right, that's Mitsuya Cider, which is a delicious apple-flavored clear soda. If you ever want a delicious apple-flavored clear soda, for example, if you have a colonoscopy planned and you need to be drinking only clear liquid for a couple of days, Mitsuya Cider will do you good. I actually had a colonoscopy. You know, this is a game where the protagonist is clearly a man in his 40s, so I feel like it's okay to talk about my colonoscopy during a playthrough of it. So, yeah, I had a colonoscopy, and I actually stopped at a Japanese supermarket and bought a Mitsuya Cider. Because I was like, wait, I can drink that, it's clear. A loud tone has informed me that I'm near a place that has the Dorayaki box. Mr. Genta, Papa Big Daddy, lawyer man, Genta, he has a soft spot for Japanese pastries. To play a Yakuza game is just to experience people jumping backward from you. Let's go on in here. I love this convenience store. I feel like it's supposed to be December, but these things up here are blowing as though the air conditioner is on. It's probably the heat. The heaters. Convenience stores are some of the few places in Japan that have these central heating and cooling. So this is actually very interesting. It's interesting to me that the game got this detail right. Look at the ceiling. It's this kind of ugly sort of synthetic ceiling tiling. And these really bright lights. It's really bright. The first thing if you ever go into a Japanese convenience store in Japan, you will immediately be shocked by how bright it is. Here's an ATM. Nice little ATM. Fun thing about the ATMs is they have mechanical, like, cherry switches. Like, really, really heavy, clicky, tactile switches. They literally have everything you could expect. So, onigiri, sandwich, a bento, just a whole bunch of delicious things. Cold beverages of all varieties. Lucky soda. Don't see any of the real brand names there, which is a shame. This is oden. Oden is a classic winter treat. It's basically just kind of vegetable garbage soaking in smelly water. Fish brine. Well, let's talk to this fellow here. Irashaimase. He says, I don't know if you can tell, this man is not, he's not Japanese. So, ooh. Take me outside, friend. What? Okay, this man is not Japanese, so he speaks with an accent. As you can hear, he's going to tell me arigato gozaimashita. Here it comes. Listen.
Arigato gozaimashita.
Arigato gozaimashita. So clearly that's a Japanese voice actor being instructed to pronounce a thing the way a foreigner would. Because Japanese people think that foreigners can't pronounce the extremely difficult word arigato gozaimashita. Apparently, they think it's very difficult for us persons born in other countries to pronounce that word in their language that has exactly 5 vowels that never change, ever. Me, an English speaker, I speak a language that has 130 different vowel sounds. I'm not going to be upset about it. So he's like, you just bought that dorayaki, that last one, didn't you? I was just thinking, you bought it just as I was thinking, I wanted to eat it. Kuite shunkan. Shunkan means moment. You bought it in the exact moment I was thinking I wanted to eat it. He's like, oh, you're some real cool dumb guys, huh? You guys sure are cool. I like their unique outfits. Oh, that's teaching me about the this whole triangle jump. So I'm going to... Last time I did this, I didn't understand. Ooh, yeah. Oh, did he say... I don't know. How can I... Can I hit? I tried this last time I played. Oh! Okay, cool. Okay, and then it's like, take a look at your phone if you want to spend your points. I'm going to go ahead. Oh, it's just like walking me over there. Thanks. Look at that font on that word skill. It's some real... Some real, like, SpiritAirlines.com looking. I've flown Spirit Airlines. Do you want to buy this skill? So what is it? Kyoryoku na finishu kougeki. It cuts down my enemy's MA. Oh. Skill gate. Really Spirit Airlines. Okay. I've flown Spirit Airlines because I like value. Oh, sorry. Hold on. I want to actually hit this dude. Oh, crikey-o. Sorry. I need to actually do the technique. Oh, it says Jiyuni Tekyo Tausi. Just defeat the enemies as you will. Oh, crikey-o. What? Did he just nut kick that guy into a somersault? You want a piece of this? The question isn't do you feel lucky. The question is how big of a piece of this do you want? How big of a piece of this do you want? From Yagami. This guy wearing this purple... call him Kono Yaro. This Yaro. Oh! Alright, here's our big boy. What are you doing, Tabo? Hamura no Kashira. Kashira means like chief. Leader, boss, captain. Captain Hamura. Hamura Kyohei. He's from that Tojo clan. Yakuza. Let go of me. Ora. Ora just means, it's just a way to end a sentence when you want to end it profanely. I'm pretty sure Tabo wouldn't be picking a fight with Chimpira like this. So that's how I know you're the one who punked with him first. This guy is like a son to our leader. You know what I'm saying? Do you see what I'm saying, buddy? And he's like, don't worry about that guy. It's okay. And then he's like, no, it's not okay, and punches him in the stomach. This sort of thing is... This is a matter of honor for us. Mensu. Mensu is from the Chinese word. Mensu. It's a... Well, we can talk about that some other time. But he's like, this is a matter of honor for me. I gotta hit this guy. Kengo, you haven't met Tabo yet, have you? Remember this man's face. Detective Yagami. Hey. Yoroshiku onegaishimasu. Nice to meet you, sir. This guy, our leader, paid this guy's education fees and he became a lawyer. He was such a good lawyer, he got a real murderer off, not guilty. Wow, that's amazing. Oh, isn't it? Like, yeah, he's real good at being a lawyer. However, once that murderer got out into the Shaba, this corrupt world, Buddhist word, he stabbed and killed his own girlfriend. What? Are you for real? So that time he was given the death sentence. Hey, did they kill him yet? He's like, no, they haven't done it yet. Oh, I bet you want him to do it real soon so you feel better about yourself, huh? He's like, here, this is the money we collected from the detective. I've already taken our fee out of it. The rest is yours. Oh, so we're just talking about work, Mr. Debt Collector? He says, oh, Kami, something. So I think, oh, I'm a debt collector for you, so you're the one who hired me, or whatever he's saying. How's Kaito? He's like, can you ask him one question for me? How long is this man we excommunicated gonna stick around my town? Oh, man. Oya-san was the boss. How is the boss? He's doing good. Oh, man, so he's just like... They're just tough guying each other. So apparently we learned there that Kaito used to work for... Well, we already knew he used to work for the Yakuza guys, but Hamura just kind of expressed a sort of a sleepy grudge where he's like sort of saying, you know, this guy, you know, we excommunicated and we kicked him out. How long is he going to stick around? Is Hamon like to kick him out? Yeah, okay, they're telling me that I can cause trouble in counter battles, get random encounters with various punks. Various punks! Jungle Boy. That's a manga kisa. So yeah, we learned that he used the word shaba there, which is like a Buddhist word that means it's just commonly used by criminals. It's like on the outside, you know. As soon as the guy got on the outside, because he said the murderer, he got free, he got out. Once he's out of the outside, I like the cut of that coat. It's a good coat cut. Yeah, so you get to hear a lot of cool tough guy slang. I could do a video breaking down tough guy slang. Or right now, I could just say, they got the graphic design here spot on this internet manga DVD. See how it's this ugly colored green font with a black stroke, and then an orange stroke on the outside of the black stroke, and then a white stroke on the outside of the black stroke, and then a blue stroke, all real big, semi-transparent on the outside of that. The graphic designers nailed it. They just completely nailed it. And I mean, it's not as though it was... It's not difficult. It's not, like, hard design to nail. But, and it, especially if you're in a city like Tokyo, there's... Excuse me? I'm trying to talk about graphic design, and this guy just wants to punk me? You want to get hit? Oh, give me your baseball bat, chump. Did his bat... His aluminum bat broke when it hit the ground? Oh man, rethink that suit, buddy. Also, rethink whatever this fighting technique is supposed to be. Anyway, yeah, they obviously, living in Tokyo, you have abundant examples of this graphic design to aspire to and compare your work to, so. I bet the 2D artists had a really good time replicating that. Jungle Boy. It's a net cafe. Basically, you go in here and you pay some money and you get to use the internet for an hour. I used a lot of those net cafes in my life. Anyone who lives in Tokyo. And it interests me now that these Yakuza games are popular. When they first came out in Japan, the first Ryuga Gotoku was, despite having a story written by Seishu Hase, who's like a real author of crime fiction, and having all of this beef shop called Waikiki, wild fried chicken, Waikiki after Hawaii. They love Hawaii and Hawaiian stuff in Japan. Popular vacation destination. I like that these games are popular now, and that the whole idea of seeing like a realistic Tokyo in a video game is like suddenly its own viable pop culture. TV dramas are full of mundane shots of realistic Tokyo, and obviously filming a TV drama in real Tokyo is much easier to do than recreating a lovingly realistic Tokyo in a video game. I find myself running into other pedestrians very often because of the camera angle. In real life, I would be seeing in first person. I wish there was a first person view mode. I think some punks are gonna try to get me. This is the center square in Kabukicho. This is a real place. Except last time I was there, it was raised like a two levels up a couple stairs of concrete. Here it's more of a flat thing with some garden chairs. Let's hit this guy with his bike. So, bicycles in Japan tend to... This guy's so strong that he can drop a bike and make it disintegrate. Bicycles in Japan are made of this... They're very heavy, the standard Japanese bike. So hitting somebody with it actually is kind of a way to kill him. I've never actually killed anybody with a Japanese bike. But I've picked a bike up and thought, you could kill somebody with this before. Picking up an object and thinking you could kill somebody with it doesn't actually make you a murderer, by the way. I like these faster, these like more, you know, these speed bikes. I've ridden some of these. I like this little variety of bike. The big bike is it's a standard, it's a classic. Here's a Club Sega. Do we want to go into Club Sega? This Club Sega actually is located... Sorry, buddy. Is actually located in this exact place in Kabukicho, right here by this square. This square where, in the early 2000s, I remember men saying this was a good place to sit and hit on girls as they walked by, which obviously doesn't work for either the men or the girls. This bowling alley is located in the same place as a real bowling alley in real life. That's a real Club Sega. Wordless emotion, power. I don't know if the actual Sega, Club Sega, at this position in Kabukicho has this sign on it, though. Since Sega made this video game, they can kind of say, yeah, it's real. Let's go in here. Another vending machine, Lucky Soda, red and black checkerboard. This is Komuro of the Dead. It's a House of the Dead. I believe I can't play it yet. I have to get further in the game, though I really want to play it. It's a House of the Dead parody set in the Yakuza series as Komuro-cho, which is wild. We have these realistic cabinets for Space Harrier. And this is Motor Raid, which is incredible. As with any sort of a building, darts. Oh my god, darts. He just kicked over that ashtray. So, in real life, if I kicked that over, this disgusting bilge water would be seeping and leaking all over the floor and smelling like terror. As in any building in Japan, there's just multiple entrances and exits. Ah, this escalator is currently out of service, so every business upstairs has to endure a stoppage. I must say there is a ring of truth in this tiling on the floor. All these triangles. Are they right triangles? Yeah, they're just a bunch of right triangles. Four right triangles makes a square, as they say. Again, just this sign for this internet cafe brings back so many memories. Again, 100 yen for the first hour, 700 yen for 3 hours. It's because that first hour is really 300. They're ripping you off. They are ripping you off. Watch it! Look at the look of anger in her face that I bumped into her. I actually genuinely feel bad for bumping into her. Let's go over here. So this says Mudyo Annai, right? Free guidance. They're playing loud music in here, and there's just a bunch of transparent print on plastic in front of bright fluorescent lights with the names of clubs. Promotions. It's advertisements for clubs inside of a room that is basically, it says free information. So, in other words, people pay to advertise in here. Sometimes there's an agent, a person who is in there who will maybe sent by one of the clubs that is advertised who will. He's just there to tell people, oh, you should go to this club, you should go to this club. And I've never really used those because, they're kind of for a specific type of dude. We're going to see if we can find another one later. There's probably some more. They usually have like a big hanging cellophane curtain in front. Oh, we see this distinctive sign for this this girls' bar. There's a girls' bar, which is just a bar where there's girls in it. Club. I remember Club Green Rose. Club Noir. At Club, 24-hour internet cafe. Somebody, am I getting honked at? You and your fake Mercedes, you want to try doing that again? Throw a bike through your front window. I almost said front glass. Front glass is what they call a windshield. Fronto Garasu. Club Emerald Hills. Just a lot of clubs. And by club, they mean you go into one of these things, it's guaranteed to just be a room. Smile Burger over there. It's just guaranteed to be a room. The Hotel New Deborah. So let's go on in. I'm going to go up to the law office up on the second floor. We remember from the opening cutscene, we're right next to Club Rose. Green Rose. I got to say, Green Rose, not really suitable for most romantic occasions. Genta law office. Saori-san. He calls her San, not Chan. Still doesn't call her by her last name. Limited, Dorayaki's. She reacts not at all. I used to work here at the Genta Law Office. I quit 3 years ago. It's only changed a little bit since then. Hoshino-kun, new lawyer. You used to your job yet? Oh, everyone's being very nice to me. Hoshino-kun. Hoshino, Ise. He looks like a punk. No, he looks all right. He's like, you were the top of your class in your bar exam.
capital.
So why don't you work at a bigger office? Why don't you work at a better office? And he's like, Yagami, I hear what you're saying over there. Corrupting my child. There are three people who I think of as my father, and Genta-sensei is one of them. He let me work at this office even before I became a lawyer. Where's Shintani-sensei? No, he's just out of... He's like, I'm glad you're not... I'm glad you missed him, because you guys don't like each other, right? He's like, oh no, he's my big brother. I respect him. I don't think he's stupid. And he's like, yeah, you think he's stupid. I know you do. You should have shown more respect to your senpai while you worked here. And he's like, don't you like dorayaki? I know you like dorayaki. I got some for you. And he's like, what? And he's like, what? Huh? Are? Huh? Did you eat all of it? And... Oh, she's still got a little bit left. She's got that red bean paste. Hanbun nara nokottemasu. There's half of one left, if that's good. Cut to commercial. I really, really wish there were fake commercials in this. I think that would be cool. Like commercials for Yakuza World products. Now I'm just stuck in the law office. Listen to the drone of the heater or the exterior. Just the traffic. They have two sofas. So, yeah. Oh, the persistent world outside. Moving car. See some NPCs. Just a little bit goes a long way. The pull cords on those blinds. They look like real cloth physics. They've got two little sofas and a table. They probably bought at like a discount store for 500 yen. Potted plant. Sort of a tropical variety, palm-like plant. A hydrangea, perhaps. They got a big, big heating and cooling unit here. Just a big standalone unit. Notice it's not like a central unit. Just blows the heat in at the door. I believe that's the sound we're hearing. The game doesn't seem to... Fire extinguisher by the door. Placed by the fire department. Fire department cares. We got a little kitchen. Fuse box inside. Another one of those tankless water heaters. No microwave, but they do have a water heater. The old man is probably suspicious of microwaves, as many older men are. There's Yagami's nameplate from his desk up there on a shelf, upside down. They have a lot of garbage and stuff, trash, just like needlessly stored in here that they haven't thrown away. It's kind of a hallmark of making a place look busy. In a Japanese drama, and also it is true to life, that they have his old nameplate up there. I find that very interesting. So, that they've kept it. They haven't thrown it away. Because they haven't ruled out that he's going to come back someday. Even though Hoshino's narking on his desk. Working on a little MacBook Pro. Old man's got his golf clubs back there. In case he wants to go hit some balls at one of Kabukicho's many indoor golf hitting. Power strip in the middle of the floor. As opposed to tucked away in like a reasonable place. It's just one power strip to plug in, one phone, and then what else is plugged into it? The cord goes behind the desk. Probably comes up on the other side for that laptop. Can't really see it. Or maybe that lamp. They don't have a whole lot of power outlets and their power strips in the middle of the floor. Very telling. I don't know. A lot of little details where they get a lot of the true-to-life stuff right here. Let's talk to the old man. He thinks of him as a father. He has three fathers, he was saying. Who's the third? Genta-sensei, do you have any sort of work for me? He's like, you want some work? How long are you going to be a detective in this dangerous town? He's like, well, in a dangerous town, there wouldn't be any work worth doing. Say, debt collection is a work for a detective? He's like, well, it's better than not working at all. You're not really a detective, you're just an everything man. Man. Come on, Yagami. What? Do you not just ever think of becoming a lawyer again? Returning to the law profession? No, I don't. Why not? Look at me. Look at my eyes. These eyes.
These eyes.
Oh, man. Everybody I look at, I just see the evil. Can I become a lawyer? That thing that happened 3 years ago, that wasn't your fault. It's just because you were a good lawyer. It was an accident. It was a law accident. Even if it was an accident. I can't let anything like that ever happen again. So, do you not have any work for me then? When I don't have anything to do, all I think about is the past. About Emi-chan. So, I'll do anything, anything you got. Just keep me busy. I just want to stay busy. How about collecting evidence for a divorce case? Get a photograph, take some photographs of him entering a love hotel. Catch him in the act of infidelity. Oh, hey, that sounds fun. I'll do that. Well, of course you would. All right, I'll send you the materials, case files later. And next time you come, don't bring me, you need no gift. Only bring me a gift when you have so much money you don't know what to do with it. What a nice, cool old man-ism for him to have. Cool old man who works in an office with accurately water-stained ceilings. You can tell this particular office has been here for a long time, unlike the cleaner ceiling of the convenience store. Well, interrupted by the phone.
Genda Horitsu Jimisho desu.
Genda Horitsu Jimisho.
Eh?
It's Genda Law Office.
Eh, imasu.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's here.
Wakarimashita.
Got it.
Yagami-san.
Yagami-san. It's Shintani.
Saiban no shouko atsume o tanamitai sou desu.
He wants to ask you to gather some evidence for him. For a murder case. A murder? What? Did we have a murder case we were working on? No. This is the first time I've heard of it. Yagami. Forget about that divorce case for a minute. Please, help Shintani. It's been 3 years since we've had a murder case. Shintani says he's at a bar on Taihei-dori. He says, go there whenever you can. Taihei-dori? A bar on Taihei-dori? You mean the bartender? Yes, bartender. A bar called Tender. That's the kind of a little joke, little English joke that Japanese writers love to do. Like they know that a bartender is a job title. They know that's like a type of dude. They don't really call bartenders in Japanese. But they know that tender is a word. It means, you know, because they know Elvis, love me tender. And they know that a bartender is the type of person. So calling a bartender is like a funny joke. Like Hideo Kojima getting hooked on meme, gene, scene, just like words that rhyme. You know. It's a good joke. It's an accurate sort of joke. I mean, accurate as in, why wouldn't it be accurate? I think he runs a little bit. His feet move a little bit too much for how he runs. If I actually hold the sprint button down, I can make him look really silly. We're just gonna... I mean, he looks kind of dumb. We're going to go to bartender. They actually tend to call bartenders some sort of a leftover borrowed Britishism. They call them master, usually. Master. I used to have a girlfriend. If you can believe that. I used to have a girlfriend who... We would always go to this bar. And I mean, she knew the guy who worked there, so it wasn't like super funny, but... she would be like, master! She would call him master. And then she would, you know, order a drink. She would call him from across the bar. Master. Master. That's the word for master. See this theater? This is actually a real movie theater in Kabukicho in real life. It's not the Commodore Theater. It's a Toho. There's like a big Godzilla statue on the side of it. And this was built in, I believe, 2010? 2011? And it was seen by many people in the neighborhood as an effort to revitalize and turn it into a family-friendly zone. This notoriously seedy neighborhood. Let's actually, can I take a picture of myself? Ooh! Hold on. Get a picture of myself in front of it. Hold on, pitch it like that. It's really hard to control because you have to move your arm, like, up and, like, farther away with your right stick and then Up and down, left and right with the left stick. Let's get me right here. Okay. So yeah, I guess this theater being added, and it's like this really nice, high quality. They got nice restaurants in there. That's Oringa Hatto. That's a real restaurant. That restaurant's real. Meanwhile, this restaurant down there on the corner with the yellow and blue sign, I believe that's a Matsuya in real life, which is, it's not, it has a similar color scheme. Watch it. Everybody trying to give me their guff. I don't want your guff. All right, let's go see what Shintani wants. Punk? Oh, I'm close to bartender. Masta. There's Mudio Annai. There's just Mudio Annai everywhere. Free Annai. Oh, wait, is this... Oh, see, this is like what I mean... No, that's a different place, sorry. I was saying that's what I mean by the weird vinyl curtain. There's gotta be a Mudio Annai around here somewhere with a vinyl curtain that I can walk into. Let's take a look at a bartender. Let's go on in. Stop wasting time. Alright, I'm in the bar. Look at this loading vestibule. It's loading a cutscene. Oh. Nice. See, that guy's wearing true bar master attire. First time I came to Kaminocho 20 years ago, this was the first place I worked, bartender. Master. He's called a master. Even though the master has gotten older, he doesn't look any different. Tabo. Shintani's in there. Oh, nice. I gotta talk to him about work. Mata kichatta. Don't drink too much, Marine. Big sister, Marine. Is that guy with you, Tabo? Oh, yeah. He's a work friend. Shintani wearing these nice sunglasses. This is work. You should have come faster. Well, given the suddenness of your calling me, you couldn't really blame me for being a little bit late. And he's like, are you ordering? He ordered a drink, and he's like, you expect me to pay? And he's like, expense it, bro. You know this guy, right? Hamura? Hamura Kyohei? He's like, oh yeah, I met him earlier today. Is he the client we're talking about here? He goes, yeah, he was arrested. He was arrested in connection to the most recent dead body. The Matsugane Gumi has a... contacted them. Oh, yeah. So in all of their cases, they always ask Genda-sensei. And he's like, Genda gave Shintani's business card to these Yakuza guys. And so they contacted him. They want him to be their lawyer. And he's like, I don't want to be the lawyer for some Yakuza. Like, you come with me. We can investigate all of this. You're used more used to Yakuza stuff than I am, right? And he goes, well, maybe. Kansai Kyōrei Kai no Yakuza. So, yeah, the dead guy from Kansai, he was found in a garbage dump. Oh, and so he knows they're talking about this most recent murder. Yeah, the one where the guy had his eyes ripped out of his head. The police, they like Hamura as the suspect. So this is a big case. There's three guys who've had their eyeballs dug out. So that sounds like serial killing. I mean, if it's all, you know, so given the similarities. So Hamura has an alibi for the first two. But for the third, they're saying he did it because he doesn't have an alibi. So it's not a serial killing? They haven't solved the other three. And the police want to look like they know what they're doing. So they think if they can catch somebody for this one, then they can just sweep the whole thing under the rug. So I gotta ask him. Oh, yeah. Whoa. Okay, so. Oh, man. So you get Renzoku, the Seikai bonus. So if you ask the right questions, basically every one of these dialogues, you have an opportunity to ask questions, and if you ask them in the right order, if you ask the right questions in the right order, then the dialogue proceeds naturally and smoothly, and you get to feel like a better detective. There's no wrong way to do this. You can ask the questions in any order you want, but you get SP bonuses if you do it the right way. So, so basically, my three things, I can get two bonuses, and if I have three things to say, so one of them won't give me a bonus, and I can say it last. I can ask it last. So, why did they arrest Hamura? It's one question. Did Hamura do it? What does Hamura say? So, I believe the proper order would be, why did they arrest Hamura? Okay, so that's, I get a bonus for that. Why did they arrest him? There are two reasons. So he's a Kansai Yakuza, the victim's a Kansai Yakuza, and he's been messing with the Tojo clan for a while. Yeah. Oh, and they're saying that also on the day of the murder, Hamura had an argument with the victim. So now we're going to ask, what does Hamura say? Because, you know, did he really do it? Like, how do we know that? That's not of a concern here, finding the facts. There, you did it. What did he say about the incident? He says, I didn't do it.
Hmm.
So you're saying he wants to be proven not guilty. So, I mean, that's actually all we really need to know, because we're not going to ask if he did it. So, I'm going to ask the guy this conversationally. Just like, do you think he actually did it? What do you think? He's like, I don't know. I don't even care. If the client wants a not guilty, that's what I'm going for. That's the lawyer's job, right? So, I think I get it. All right, I think I got it. Let's get out of here. I'll go first. Or you go first, sorry. I got to make a couple of phone calls. And we're going to go meet at the jail, at the holding tank. Also known as the crime hole. Oh, this details have been added to my case file. Ooh, details about murder. Let's take a look. Yeah, so then we get the whole case just kind of spelled out there for us. In nice plain Japanese. Hamura Kyohei, 52 years old, is the suspect. And the victim, who's the victim? Oh yeah, so then we get all the persons of interest, Kankeisha related peoples. They all get kind of thrown in up here. So let's actually close that up. I get my side cases, my Todo list. So Todo, get in a taxi, go to the jail. All right, taking a taxi to jail. You leaving now, Tabo? You seem busy lately. Oh, maybe. I might have some work for you if you come back later. There was a guy who wanted something. A guy who wanted to know if you could do something for him. He's like, oh, if I can get a job, that'd be nice. Come on back again sometime and I'll tell you. So in other words, I now have two places I can get a mission from. We got the old man at the Genda law office who's like, I can give you with the, what do you call it? The divorce case, evidence gathering mission. Pizza La's a real Japanese delivery pizza place. Japan standard. People just violently jumping away from me as I walk by. I'm not that scary. I know I'm a hard dude, but I'm not. Oh, whoa, here you go. This is an Annai station with these weird vinyl banners. Nobody in here, though. So, me and my friend went into one of these just once. And I mean, we used to hang out in Shinjuku Kabukicho a lot. Because, I mean, not for any seedy reason. We were there because there was always a lot of punk rock and noise rock shows that were happening in that neighborhood. Places like, you know, just little places. Just all over the place. Little clubs. Club ACB or whatever. And we always wondered what these were. And there's just this thundering, like, Eurobeat music playing in here. So we went into one once, because my friend's like, let's go in. And we were standing in here for like 2 seconds, and there was like one guy with like a cold mask on his face, and he was just standing, and a hat on, and he was just standing in front of one of them, like looking at it. And then there's a door, kind of much like this one, and a guy just comes out of the door and walks up to us and makes an X out of his forearms and is like, and says, not for you. not for you, in English. It's like, and he like kind of like ushers us out. And my friend Stabo, he just says, Murio Annai, over and over again to the guy. And the guy's like, not for you. And then Stabo says, Annai shite kudasai, guide us. Because it says free guidance. And that's the end of that story. They didn't want to guide us to any of their clubs. Because they figured we couldn't speak their language and thus we would, cause trouble. Again, another one of these internet cafes. Every single time you see one of these, first of all, look at the starbursts around those lights. Does our main character have cataracts? Dry eyes? Does the lens have a little bit of Vaseline or a little bit of human skin oil on it? Are you seeing this displaced shadow over here on the left over the car of the blinking lights? Is that a lens flare effect of the camera? It's subtle and rich. Seeing one of these signs just brings back the memories of going to one of these internet cafes. It says Furii Dorinku on the right side, Internet and Komiku. They have comics. You sit down at a little desk and you drink ice cold beverages out of these little plastic tumblers. Fill it up with ice chips. A little bit of Coke. Carbonation is always just right. That's what Shinjuku Kabukicho is to me. I'm gonna get in this taxi. Give me that taxi, big boy. Tozai Musa. Get me in there. No. I gotta get on the right pixel. 410 yen? You can't get anywhere in Tokyo for 410 yen in a taxi. It's like 660 minimum. And we're going to some jail? Shippatsu itashimasu. Shippatsu is a good word. It means depart. Shippatsu. I love a good shippatsu. Oh, here we are at the jail. I'm stretching, sorry.
Yo.
Visitor room. Yo. Thanks for coming to see me. Well, if you want to laugh, go ahead and laugh, he says. Hamura, I'm Shintani from the Genda Horitsu Jimusho, Genda Law Office. One of your men told us to come here. Oh, nice to meet you, Shintani. Well, let's be friends. He just says, let's be friends, like we are with Genda-sensei. Well, let's get started. We have a lot to ask you. We're going to go ahead and let Yagami run the questions. Well, that's good. I'm glad of that, he says. So you were arrested for murder. So do you have any sort of guesses as to why that might be? What? What do you mean, guesses? He's asking if you did it. What do you think? Whether I did it or not, your job is to get me out of here, right? And he says, no, it's not. If I find proof that you did it, you'll let it go? No. I will give it to the police, and I will have you sent to prison. What? You're the one who got a real murderer? Not guilty? That was 3 years ago. There was a large chance that he was innocent, and that's why I believed him. But then after that, Okubo, he stabbed his lover and lit a fire. They keep reminding us of that. Your eyes were clouded by the possibility of getting a not guilty verdict, the rare not guilty verdict, so you didn't see the truth. And then he goes, there was a reasonable doubt, and he says, tell his dead girlfriend about the reasonable doubt. Shoot! A lot of tension here. These guys need to hug it out, but the glass is getting in the way. And he's like, we should be talking about the case now. Do you have questions? And he's like, all right, I guess we gotta get back to work. Gotta work with this guy. Sorry for the rudeness. So, the victim is this guy, 34-year-old Kume is his name. He was found dead in a garbage zone at 6 a.m. on the 4th of December. So they think you did it. What did you say? Did you say anything to the police? Do they have any kind of a proof for why they might have arrested you? I don't know. How would I know that? Right, Shintani-sensei? Yeah, I suppose. What kind of proof the police have? We can't confirm what they have. So we just have to go by what... You've got to help us figure out what they might have. Anything you want to ask, Hamura-san? Okay, so here we go. Can I ask about the victim? Can I ask about the argument he had with the victim? Ask about what the police are doing? Ask about his alibi? So we're going to ask about the argument he had first. So I think first I want to ask about the argument he had with the victim before I ask about the victim. So let's talk about what happened before we... hold on. I want to ask about the victim first. So who's the victim? Let's talk about him. Kume Shiro, 34 years old. An underling in the Kyorei Kai. So was he there alone? I don't feel like he would be alone. It would be weird. Oh no, there was one more. His aniki, his senpai, his upperling. There were, including me, there were five of the Matsuganegumi. So, let's ask about the argument. That's my two star. So where did this fight start? Is that a club called Amur on Suppondori? I had a couple of young guys from the group, and we were glaring at each other. I was glaring at that guy. I couldn't let myself be looked at like that by a guy from the Kansai. He says, what time was that? He says, I believe it was around 9 o'clock. So he looked at you and that was it? No, he tried to run away, so we grabbed him. And we pulled him into the club Amur. He's like, what? He's like, oh, we heard it was an argument. Are you saying it was a... So you say you beat this guy up? You and a bunch of dudes beat him up? It wasn't just an argument? And he's like, yeah, we went inside the shop, made everybody leave. But we didn't kill him. And then we let him out the back door. And then we left. At around midnight or a little bit before. I see. So he beat the guy up, and in the morning he was found with his eyes ripped out. So even if I were the police, I would arrest you for that. We're going to ask about his alibi if he has one. Ooh, all three. What about your alibi? Do you have one? Where were you at the time the victim would have been killed? From 2 a.m. to 3 a.m., he was asked, the police asked him a lot, like where he was at that time. And he says he was at a sauna. Sauna Goten. He was at a sauna until the morning. But you don't have proof that you were there, right? If you did have that proof, they probably wouldn't have arrested you. He's like, yeah, they don't have any proof. Well, let's ask about the cops. Anyway, I've got my three stars. Conversationally. What, who's the detective? Kuroiwa is the detective. He's been in charge of the basically the boss is saying saying he's a detective, he just has something against Yakuza. He doesn't like Yakuza. So the detective is a do-gooder who doesn't like people who live by breaking the rules. He's a real rule lover. Now it's time to, I suppose we're going to want to see how good Big Boy's alibi is. He says he was at a sauna all night. There's Don Quixote. Tax-free shop. He says go to the sauna and confirm Hamura's alibi. If we can prove the alibi, then we can keep this from going to court. Report. Give me your full report tomorrow. All right. We got more stuff in the case file. Let's see what we got. Main case? Oh, Daddy loves a case. We got new guys. Here's the victim. Got into an argument with Hamura at around 9 p.m. on the evening of the 3rd. And he was dragged in a club of more. And beaten up. And then... the next day he was found dead with his eyes ripped out. Eyeballs ripped out. You know what they call that? It's called enucleation. That's what they call dismemberment is when you have an arm ripped off. Enucleation is when you have an eye ripped out. Fun fact. It's something everybody should know. All right. Okay. So I'm going to go to the sauna. Check it out at the sauna. I'm gonna run wild down this wild alley. That guy has a mask on his face, doesn't wanna either get germs or spread germs. I love running wild. All you have to do is tap the X button and you just start running. Oh man, hitting that thing barely stopped him. Oh, this says Terekura. Terekura means telephone club. Telephone kurabu. It's you register your name and then you get phone calls from... it's like a dating service. I don't know if those work, but I used to live above one. I mean, it was very quiet. They didn't make any noise in there. There's 3,900 yen to join.
Yeah.
He's like, well, I'm not a customer, but I just want to ask you a question. He's like, what? Do you know about the Yakuza who was recently killed with his eyeballs ripped out? And he goes, oh yeah, some detectives were asking me about that. I told them that the suspect was not here at the time. What, so what are you? Are you a reporter? And he's like, well, something like a reporter. So this is a guy, the young boss, Hamura. Was he here at the time? And he's like, I told the cops. I was at the reception desk that night. Though I sure don't remember who any of my customers were. And he's like, oh yeah, this guy does not remember the face of the boss of the Kashida. So, he can't confirm the alibi. Do a lot of people come in and out of here? And he says, yeah, up until the last train runs. However, usually it's just people who are waiting out the first train of the morning because they missed the last train. So, after the last train, a lot of customers stay. They don't leave. They just come in and stay. So all I have to do is confirm that he came in the shop. And he's like, yeah, that's what the police were saying. So, okay, so as long as we can prove that he came in that night. So, like, okay, the boss, this guy who was at the reception desk says he doesn't remember anyone leaving the sauna before the first train. This is a phenomenon in Tokyo. The The trains stop running at around midnight, and then they don't start again until about 5 or 4 or 5 in the morning. So most people, they need somewhere to go for the night if they miss the last train. And a sauna is a heck of a place to do that, because you can just stay all night. You can sit in the sauna. You can sit in the bathtub. There's a rest area. It's locked behind a door. There's a door you go in, and once you're behind the door, once you've paid your dues and you've gone in and you've locked all your stuff in a locker and you've retrieved a towel and you've gone inside, like, the person at the reception desk would know if anybody is leaving. So he's saying all they have to do is, I guess this is a cultural thing. I wonder how well this is going to come across in the translation when this game actually comes out in English. If you haven't been to a Japanese sauna in a nightlife district in the vicinity of a large train station before, you might not understand why this is such a big deal. So he's saying they need to be able to prove that the guy went in there. They don't have to be able to prove when he came out, because he's like, do you have a security camera inside? Something to check. And he's like, yeah, we do, except it automatically is deleted every 3 days. So even at the time the police came, it had already deleted itself. 3 days is not long enough. He's like, okay, I got it. Well, sorry for bothering you. And he's like, maybe we should talk to some other people around here. So maybe we should talk to some other people around here. Who else is there? They have word bubbles. Hello. Are you always standing here? On the night of the 3rd. Did you see people going in and out of the shop? Yada chou ukeru. She ends her sentence in chou ukeru, which is a slangy way for a girl to say, you're so cool. Or ukeru means I love it. Chou ukeru means super I love it. Ukeru just means I receive it. I like it. I take it. I got it. I'm into it. It's kind of a speech habit of trendy girls. Can I talk to you for a second? On the night of the 3rd, there was a Yakuza who went into the club. What? I don't remember stuff from that long ago. That's ancient history. You're getting in the way of my work. Get out of here. That guy sucks. He is definitely dressed appropriately for this winter evening, though. Big old beefy turtleneck under a sort of a nice warm winter jacket. This guy looks like a regular Nissan. If you saw this guy in the street, you'd call him Nissan. Look at his really bad sideburns. Ill-advised sideburns, man. Oh, so he's asking, did you see it? Looking for a Yakuza who went into the club, etc., etc. Did you see anything? And was this guy, Hamura? Do you know this guy? I don't know that guy. But there are a lot of Yakuza in this town. The night of the 3rd, huh? There was a host who got punched in the face around here. By a Yakuza? Yeah. He didn't seem to get hurt too much, but it was around 12 o'clock, a little later than that. On the night of the incident, a Yakuza punched a host. Though when I saw it, the Yakuza had already left, but the hosts were having a fit about it. So how was that? Do I help? Does this information help you? He's like, oh, do we not know where that host is from or who he is? And he's like, I don't know. The hosts all kind of look the same, don't they? Even if I saw his face, I probably wouldn't remember. Are there any other people who saw this happen? And he's like, I don't know. So he's like, maybe I should dig deeper. It's like, thank you for your cooperation. Okay. こんなところ だな. He's like, this is maybe. So he's like, maybe I've got enough for tonight. And he's talking about going home. So I just go back to Yagami Jimisho and sleep. So that guy says that there was a host. Wow. Wow. Oh my god, get away from me, punks. So a host, in case you don't know what a host is, guy who works at a host club. Just a cool guy that girls will pay money to just drink with this cool guy. It's a booming industry. There's a really good documentary about it on YouTube. from a long time ago. I remember first seeing it on Google Video. If you want to know more about what a host is, my friend Stabo was once scouted by a host club. My friend Stabo from earlier in the story, my Kabukicho buddy. He was a host for about a week. And it's true, they all do have similar faces. They do their faces up the same. They put makeup on. They do their hair the same. They wear the same kind of clothes. I don't think they all look exactly the same as our Aniki back there. Not Aniki. Nissan. As our Nissan said. Here's my Aniki. Oh. Kaito-san.
What?
How you doing, Kaito-san?
Kaito-san?
I thought you would have gone home by now. Like, even if I go home, I'll just sleep. So I was here. Or I was out drinking. And you're drinking here now, huh? You're drinking my alcohol. So? Do we got work? It's like the Dorayaki did the trick. Collecting evidence for a murder. For Genda Jimushu. I thought they've been doing public work for a while. Not police work. Well, it's the Matsuganegumi Yakuza. It's that murder from the other day. They're reminding us of the murder again. This is... Oh, you mean the one with the guy who had his eyes ripped out? Yeah. I was... We went and saw him. He says he's innocent. Oh, yeah? I bet he is. Slam that glass down. Watch the table, bro. You don't like it, huh? And it's Hamura, the guy who kicked you out of your Yakuza group. I wasn't exactly kicked out by him, per se. Don't worry. If you're the one giving me the orders, I'll do the job, buddy. He's saying, because he's a manly man. He's cool with working to defend the guy who got him kicked out of his Yakuza group. Since we were talking about heating and cooling earlier, I just want to point out they have one of these. They have a wall unit, like a big beefy sort of heating and cooling unit up there. Just a little one, like more for like a personal domestic use. Not one of the large ones that we saw in the larger law office or the central ones that we saw in the convenience store. Well, that's all you need to know about heating and cooling in metropolitan Tokyo. Yasumimasu ka? Will you rest? Heck yes. I will rest. And I guess that's the end of day one of the game. He wakes up in the morning. See a little dust in the sunlight. This defamiliarized iPhone marimba ringtone.
Moshimoshi.
Shintani da.
It's Shintani.
Nakamichi-dori made
kiteru.
He's at Nakamichi-dori.
Mijore tte kissaten ga aru na.
At a cafe called Mijore. Oh, you're summoning me suddenly once again, huh, Shintani-sensei? Don't complain. I thought you liked being busy. Crikey. Well, I guess we gotta go to this cafe Mijore. And hold on, I wanna just squeeze my leather once more. Oh my god, such a squeeze. Let's get the heck out of here. So, big boy Shintani. Now we get to see Kamurocho during the day. Big boy Shintani has a job for me. Is it a good job? We're about to find out. Well, he doesn't have a job for me. He's got an update. Wow, the reflection of that red car makes that puddle look like blood. And it reminds me of the blood of that day. These yellow rubberized tiles on the ground are for guiding the sight impaired. The little dots represent the end of a curb, like the beginning of a street, and the lines indicate the direction that traffic flows. Yakitori. I mean, again, this graphic design is spot on for Japanese street signage. This brick pattern, this fancy brick pattern, you know, a little bit, just a little bit of architectural attention to detail can make all the difference for making a city feel like a luxurious place. And just the way they lay bricks on the roads and the sidewalks in Japan, just this kind of mildly, just the slightest insinuation, the slightest hint of ornateness makes it feel fancy. And look at these squiggly bricks. I mean, this is what it's like in Tokyo. It's the sort of thing you don't get in New York. You just have sidewalks are just ugly, just stuff everywhere. Smile Burger's not a real chain. Sorry, Smile Burger. Anything else? Karaoke-kan is a real chain. I mean, that's what the red lettering on the blue sign over there says. That's Karaoke-kan. Karaoke-kan is, I suppose, the largest karaoke chain. Well, that's a big cone. It's the largest karaoke chain in Japan. Karaoke, we might call it. Oh my god, that's exactly what the front desk looks like. Japan country spirit, since 1990. I love Karaoke-kan. Not as much as I love Paseda Karaoke, which is better. They have Honey Toast there at Paseda. Honey Toast is it's always advertised at the front of a karaoke shop. It's just bread with some honey and some sweetness on it. They want you to eat Honey Toast. They advertise it up front. They want you to eat it because it's just that stuff will get stuck in your throat. It's like eating a kitchen sponge. I mean, it is like feasting on a kitchen sponge. Oh, here's a Cafe Mijore. I like the MJ on the cup. Looks like a real place. Oh, there's my bud. I'm over here. Sit. These chairs are nice. The interior is nice. This is just a kind of like fancy little second floor place, you might say. I asked everybody around the sauna. Could not prove the Kashiro's alibi. Boss man. So why'd you call me here, man? I got some new information. Here. Look at this. The police have yet to release this to the media. Though it's footage from the security camera from before the Amur incident. You can see Hamura very clearly. So are you saying this is footage of them having an argument? Or having a fight? No wonder the police arrested him. Are you ready? I'm gonna play it. Oh my god, look at that sweet filter. Oh my god, they're fighting. They're fighting. So you can see him, you can clearly see him get pulled in. They're pulling Kume in. Yeah, okay. Rewinds it back a bit. I love this sort of thing. Who's this guy running away? Is that Kume's Aniki? He's like, that must be his big brother character guy. We know his name. Murase Akira. He's also part of the Kyōreikai. It seems that the police have confirmed he's still somewhere in Kamurocho. There must be a Kyōreikai office somewhere here. This is a pretty heck of a good bit of footage here. Oh, and there's also, there's more. We have a footage of 1 hour after that. What is it? The continued footage. I wonder what it will show. You can see 1 hour later, Hamura and Kume are still inside, but everyone else leaves the shop at the same time. So they're still inside the shop. Why did just the two of them stay inside? And he's like, I don't know. Hamura didn't mention any of this to us. This was at 10 p.m. So there's 4 hours between this and him being killed. So what were they doing inside of this club together? So before... Okay, so now he's thinking. The blue text means big boy's thinking. Big boy with his very styled hair. So right before the incident, Hamada and the victim, Kume, were alone together. And there's no doubt about it. They were alone together inside of this club. So what did they do? What were they doing in there? So he says he went out, he let Kume out, and then he went to the sauna by himself. So this is this is the Tencho, the manager of Amuru. Let me tell you something. You're the lawyer. You're the one who confirms what evidence is needed to take it to a case. I'm the investigator. I mean, but aren't you going to talk to that manager, though? He's like, well, yeah, of course I am. I just don't like being ordered around by you. So he's saying, let me be in charge of the investigation. Okay, so we got more information in the case file. What's in the case file? Let's take a look. And we got Sonoman. Sonoman ended up in the case file. This is the Aniki boy, and this is the Amur club owner. So we gotta go ahead and find... We're gonna go to Club Amur. Let's go down these brilliant stairs. Can I take the elevator? Do I want to be a big, dumb dog? Wait, I can. Wait, I can go upstairs? Upstairs? I'm gonna have to go up to floor 3 and see what's up here. Mantai Netto Cafe. Netto Cafe. I don't want to go there. I don't want to go to the Net Cafe. Let's go up the stairs. Look at this persistent geometry. Take me up. What's in here? Hello? I'm here. Fire escape. This is not how I planned on exiting this building. Is me stuck? What? Oh, hold on. Wow, way to just cool guy and then jostle the trash cans. Oh. Want me to hit you with a motorcycle? Oh, I can't pick that motorcycle. I broke the bike. All right, you freaks. He said, "Shinit." Oh my god, I dizzied him. I'm gonna run off the wall again. God, I'm a mad dog murderer. I'm a stone cold killer. Man, he's just still nerve twitching. These men are dead. These fellows are dusted. I go this way. Excellent. Let's continue on our little quest. I'm gonna go down this way. As with navigating any Tokyo street in real life, it's a little bit disorienting. You don't know which street is gonna continue through to where. Sorry to punk you guys, but I had to. These guys want a piece? Okay, hold on. Let me throttle these. I'm not fighting very smartly. I'm sorry. I'm gonna grab you. I'm gonna EX action you. Oh, what? What? You dead? You dead, bro? These guys do not require any, like, technique from me. Oh, did he drop item? Jikan kuchatta. You ate some of my time. 8,000 yen? Oh my god! That's enough to buy the video game Judge Eyes. Actually, this game was, like, 8,000 yen to buy the regular version of. Which is why I just went all the way and bought the, deluxe edition. The digital deluxe. The fun thing about buying the digital deluxe is you don't need to wait for it to arrive from Japan. Club Amur. Oh, there was a security camera here. Oh, yeah, here's the funny part. He's like, I should probably figure out where the security camera was. So he's looking at this is funny. Like before he goes into the club, he just has to know exactly where the security camera was that captured the security footage. So there it is up in the corner. That's it. That's the thing. And now I can make it bigger. So I can see clearly this little lighted sign. So I need to find it. It's clearly like right over here, right? Right? No, wait. It's right over here. Here it is. That's, I believe that is a security camera. I did it. Atta. Mohan kamera wa jiken no atta yoru kore ga amuru mae o rokuga shite ita. Sore ja amuru no tenchou no hanashi wo kiite miru to suru ka. Let's talk to the manager of the club. That's all I needed to do. He just needed to know if it was there. Traffic cone got in the way. I foot floppied over it. Amur. Give me that club. Where's that big whiskey at? Who the heck are you? What are you doing here? No, I came here to ask a question. Do you have time right now? It's about the incident on the night of December 3rd. Did you see a man in a black car? Did you see a black car? Oh, I wasn't here that night. You probably want to ask the manager. He doesn't come until nighttime. So the manager, you mean this guy? He goes, what? Yeah? Tell me his name. Aragaki. Can you not contact him? I need to talk to him. Now. He's like, okay, I'll call him now. Oh, he's got his phone turned off. That guy, he always has it turned off during the day. He's probably out playing around town. Kamurocho. He's in Kamurocho. Yeah. Okay. Well, I'll go look for him. Yeah, I mean, you can try that, but like how? You're just gonna go walk around the town? Like, well, if you have any guesses as to where he might be, that would help me out. Also, I'm good at finding people. Oh, so you're one of those guys. Have a good time. Good luck. Thanks. Thanks for your help. So, it's like, oh, there was a rear entrance. Maybe we should check out the rear. Is he going to let me go out here? You going to let me out this door, tiger? And he's letting me out. That guy looks like a tiger. Okay. Here's the exit. Those little kids. Those low socks. Oh! It's a Bohan camera. Sekkaku aru no ni kowareten no ka. Ah. Sekkaku aru means at last it was here. Or at last it is here. It means like, it's a neat nuance of Japanese to be like, it's here, and god darn it, it's quantitative, it's broken. So if the camera were alive, it would have shown someone leaving the back door. Takes a picture of it just as proof that, you know, proof that he has no proof. You know what they say? No proof of something doesn't mean proof to the contrary. And proof of no proof is better than no proof. It's like, oh, I think if I want to find the Tencho. Tencho means the boss of store or the manager. If I want to find him, I should ask Aitsu, that guy, at Net Cafe Mantai, which I was just in front of. Oh, we got more stuff in the case file. What do we got? Amuru Tencho, namae wa Aragaki. Mr. Aragaki, Tencho. What do we got here? Got some photos. What about that? What about this? What about this? Oh, yeah. Well, here's what I say in times like this. I say, let's kill. It's my new catchphrase. Let's kill. Wait, what? How do I... Am I just a dumpster man now? Oh, that's not a door, bro. Okay, hold on. What? Krikerino. Oh, here it is. Let's squinch. Oh, yeah. Listen to that leather breathe. We're gonna go this way. Excuse me. Man, I did not want to bump into her. Ah. Machi no Chinpira. Let's go, Chinpira Tachi. Oh my god! Shinera. I don't know my combos. Oh, I just straight freaked that guy to the floor. Nice little suit you got there. It'd be a shame if you got blood and vomit all over it. He got flipped upside down. You got balloon animaled, idiot. Any kind of money lying on the ground? No. I'm not gonna bump into that guy. I did it. I avoided bumping into him. Jump. So we're going to this net cafe, Montai. We're going to Montai. Utapari. I think it's Utapari. Where's Montai? Commodore Chinimals? Cinema animals? Sin animals? What are sin animals? Is that like Madagascar or Ice Age? Like a cinema movie about animals? Where am I going? What building? Oh, it's in here. This is Net Cafe Montai. Kick me in here. I'm gonna ride the escalator because the world is my theme park. Look at those feet placements. Inverse kinematics. Is that what chinimals are? Chinematics? My feet. Hello? So this brings back the memory of being in a lot of these Tokyo internet cafes. If you've ever spent the night in Tokyo unable to take the train home because it's too late, you've been to a place like this. You've definitely been to a place like this. These little tiny rooms with a little cushion on the ground, computer monitor, little tower case, tissues, waste basket, headphones hanging on a hook, hanger for your goddarn jacket. And of course, this little sign on here tells you how much the shower costs. I love it. You can take a shower in here. You can order food. There's usually a button. Where's the button? It's like a little button you can press to order. Maybe it's on the desk. Can't see in there. They won't let me in. There's usually a little button you can press to summon someone to your booth. Oh my god, drinks? So they have vending machines, but usually you're going to drink out of this. It says Big Bubble Galaxy. Super Big Bublio Brothers. Super Bublio Galaxy. Super Bublio Odyssey. Big Bubble Galaxy, everybody. That's where I'm from. That's where my planet is. A little bit of orange juice. No, it's Mekon. It's a tangerine juice. Usually there would be little cups and glasses, plastic tumblers down here. This looks like stands for, like, some sort of fresh juices. No, this is where the glasses would be. They would... Wait, there are glasses in there. It's hard to see with the contrast. So, yeah, you would get drinks of this. You know, before I had my colonoscopy, I had an endoscopy, and the gastroenterologist said that the bottom of my esophagus resembled someone who had smoked for several years. And he was like, have you smoked for several years in your life at one point? Did you smoke? And I was like, no. People just loitering around in here. You know, you want to stand up, stretch your legs. Smoking room. Yeah, here's a little smoking room. And I was like, no, I haven't smoked. But then I immediately thought of all my time in these Japanese internet cafes, where in the early 2000s, especially somewhere like Shinjuku, much as this glass looks as though it's seen better days and it's all scarred up and scratched up, much as this glass looks like this, I feel like this is a relatively new addition to this internet cafe. A place like this, you would have been smoking at your desk. Can I smoke? Ippuku suru. Chotto ippuku. Shimatta. He's out of cigarettes. Hecko. Well, we're just going to do it secondhand style, I guess. How you boys doing? So yeah, I told him that, you know, I'd been in a lot of Japanese internet cafes, and he's like, is it full of smoke there? And I was like, yeah. Also, I worked in an office, and it was full of smoke. He was telling me I have something called Barrett's esophagus. which I immediately thought, oh, that's a character in Final Fantasy VII. Though Barrett's esophagus means that you have like this weathering of the bottom of your esophagus from being around a lot of cigarette smoke. Though when I thought of the internet cafes, I also thought of the coffee they have here. Like, the coffee is so hard and so strong and so sludgy and so gross. I kind of want some right now. All I have is this office coffee, though. Let's drink some of this. Ugh. Not quite the same as Tokyo Internet Cafe. Bilge and sludge. You'd swear you were in Belgium, because it's real bilge in... It's bilge, it's swill. You know, I don't know where this guy is. He's in one of these booths. I can see the flag on the map. Oh, sorry. You should find somewhere else to be, old man. Oh, here he is. This guy looks like a real computer dude. Otacon? He's Otacon. Did you come to play video games with me, he says? Oh, of course you didn't. What do you want? He's got a Google Glass on. He's straight up got a Google Glass. Tsukumo Makoto. He has an interesting name and an interesting last name. He can connect to the internet and access any information as a hacker. So yeah, he's a real information seller. So you're here about helping out a detective, huh? Or are you looking for a cat? Missing person? Actually, a person. Manager of the club, Amur. Name Aragaki. There's a chance he's playing around in this neighborhood right now, hanging out. I'll break my bones if I search each shop one at a time. Nice little idiomatic expression. I'll break my bones if I search. Meaning it would be a lot of work. Let me see your smaho. Smaho? Again, we've learned that means smartphone. Smaho. He was in a band called Smapu, so... Which actually was way before the invention of a smartphone. Yutta.
Yutta? Ah.
So he's got... Yutta is the name of a Tsubiyaki no... Tsubiyaki no Apuri. A Tsubiyaki app, a Whisper app. They're talking about Twitter. Basically, they have an in-world sort of Twitter. He's going to intrude on the system of Yuta, and he's going to steal their data. He's hacking into Twitter, or the world's version of Twitter, Yuta. Yeah, let's insert let's put in a search word. Let's start with a name. Aragaki, there it is, boom. I like that astronaut avatar. Reminds me of the... There's an album by Sotai Seiridon, Theory of Relativity. They have a little EP that has that exact stock photo of an astronaut as the cover. He's looking at tweets that are happening in the neighborhood. Neighborhood tweets. Going to try to locate this guy. There's 128. We're going to have to squeeze it a little bit more. Oh, yeah? Some person's name is Sharkuma. Their name is Samekuma, shark bear. Kuma means bear, shark means shark. Same means shark. I'm gonna insert more. He's teaching this detective how to Google. He's like, Aragaki and Club Amur. Oh, there we go. Look at that. We found one. We reduced it down to just one. Is this a tweet by Aragaki? No, no. Though this might become a big clue. It's a tweet from 10 minutes ago. So there's a chance he's in the neighborhood. I'm not sure this is exactly how Twitter works. This is a little bit the Dark Knight, kind of. Maybe go to that area and ask around. All right, I'll go ask in the area right now. Oh, so now he's like, I put a mark for the tweet on your map app. It might help you out. Thanks, you helped me. You should go outside sometime. Yeah? Nah, don't feel like it, he says. Thanks, Otacon. Crikey. Me go outside? There's nobody at the front desk who will assist me. I want to use the internet. There's a umbrellas, cheap umbrellas for sale in case you go in at a time it is not raining and it begins to rain while you're in there and you need to leave. Copy machine and a printer in case you need to print documents. I remember printing out a lot of apartment applications and such from these during my first wild, youthful days in Tokyo. I met my roommate in an internet cafe in Kabukicho. That's a lie. I met him in an internet cafe in Ikebukuro. Close enough, though. I don't want to embellish things. We were both in the same internet cafe, and we'd posted on the same message board. He was a Japanese dude from Osaka. He's coming up to the big city. He had some friends who did actually work for the Yakuza. And I mean, I'm saying that matter-of-factly, I didn't work for the Yakuza. Well, I worked at a school that was owned by the Yakuza once, but that's... Oh, can't go! Law-abiding citizen does not want to go through this red... This red thing. Wet to kitchen? Sandwich coffee? I don't know, sandwich coffee. That's all I've got for that. I don't even have a joke for sandwich coffee. Oh, it's Gyukaku. So Gyukaku is a real restaurant. It's a yakiniku restaurant. Gyukaku's real. It's funny because Don Quixote was the only real thing in the first Yakuza game. And now it's become filled with... this is a Chinese restaurant. Now the place has become completely filled with stuff that's real. This is Matsuya, but it's not Matsuya. Let me go this way? Let's go this way. So I have to get into the red zone. Romance. There's romance on the second floor. I guess that's just a coffee shop. Cafe bar. Oh, can't go up there. It's not actually a real location. Jungle Boy. We've been here before. Popo convenience store. I need to find where our guy is. Golden Triangle. Is that like the golden ratio? Video annai. Annai shite kudasai. That means guide me, in case you forgot. That guy was walking up against the sign. I gotta say, I love this. This really feels like being in Kabukicho in the morning. I have some crazy memories of being in Kabukicho in the morning. Look at this guy's nice little carry-all that he's got. His rolled-up jeans, street fashion trends, ahoy. Oh, sorry. Two-way briefcase on that guy with the jeans and the jacket. Rethink that, buddy. What is that poster that has that weird person on it, is what that lady was saying. Where is the guy? I want to make my guy drink a cup of coffee. That's how we're going to end this. We're going to go get a cup of coffee. Oh, heck oh, dude's in the park. What's up, bro? Oh, man. Okay, everybody's afraid of my dude. My dude exudes such testosterone that nobody wants to get near him. Am I doing this wrong? No. I'm in the right zone. I just need to find him. I gotta find the dude. He's in here somewhere. Boy, oh boy, being a detective sure is hard. I need to search for the person who... Oh, some punks want to... Some punks, they desire to be turned into trash. Let's actually purchase a skill or two. What do we got? Yeah, you can actually buy skills mid-battle. This is fun. I want to buy this charge attack. Let's do it. Hold down the triangle button to charge. Oh, heck oh. What? Oh, me got bat. Who's next? Home run, idiot. I hit him so hard, I broke the bat in his hands. Heat action. What? Jikan kuchatta. Yeah, oh man. Guy with the sweet bag has given me a round of big man applause. So who's next? You? Wait, is this the guy who tweeted? It says up in the corner, Tsubiyaita otoku wo sagasu. Find the man who tweeted.
Chotto ii.
Yagami-san janai. How do you know me? He had just immediately folded his arms. I'm looking for the manager of Club Amour. Do you know where he might be? Oh, I saw him a minute ago, recently. He seemed like he was in a real bad mood. He must have lost at pachinko. So where do you think he went after losing at pachinko? Taihei Dori, no. He went to Taihei Dori. He might have gone to eat some sushi. What? Sushi? So he lost at pachinko, and you're saying that he would then go eat a fancy meal like sushi? I don't know. I mean, why not go when you lose? Don't you want to eat something nice? Lose 500,000 yen? Go eat something fancy. But then when you win, don't you want to just save the money and do something, only responsible things with it? Well, you know, maybe you're right. Anyway, what sushi shop do you think? You said a sushi shop? All right, thanks. Guy giving us a little life advice. When you lose at pachinko, that's the best time to go eat fancy food. I mean, I gotta say, seems right to me. Look at his jacket flying up as he runs. I think it's a little bit too much. I don't think he's running fast enough for it to fly up. I don't understand the wind direction in this neighborhood. Some fools need their bones to be turned into garbage. Might you appreciate an ending? Holy Lord! You want to get owned? That's a heck of a pose to strike. He's like, you guys better behave yourselves. Nothing like saying something coldly avuncular after violently owning some tough dudes on the street. I'm gonna keep strutting. The way it goes, Yagami, tough dudes they're like sharks. They gotta keep strutting or they die. Gotta keep strutting. Strutting right into the sushi shop. Oh, we found the tweets. Kosozan. Ah, that's what the little things are above people. Look at that creepy statue. Are you Aragaki? He's like, yeah, who are you? I'm from Yagami Tante Jimisho. I need to talk about the incident on the night of the 3rd. Oh, that? Yeah, I don't know. Sorry. I don't know. Sorry, man. You don't not know about it. No, really, I don't. Oh, shall I prove it to you? I can prove that you were involved in the incident. Okay, so. That's a picture of a broken security camera. That doesn't prove anything. It's proof of no proof. This is the fight. These are the dudes leaving, so I remember he was in the photos of the dude, or the image of the dudes leaving. I should show him the other one and see what happens. Should see what happens if I pick the wrong one. No, we're gonna pick the right one. I don't care. I don't want to be wrong. Since somebody in the comments would be like, you were wrong. Korida, this. The day of the incident. You were with the Matsuganegumi dudes as they left the club. And all that was left in the shop was Hamura and Kume. So you are absolutely involved. Well, heck, you got me. Don't worry, I'm not some kind of weirdo. I'm actually working to help clear Hamura's name. If you have some time, I would like to talk to you. Okay. Well, yes, he says. Okay. Well, yes, he's going to cooperate. The little boy is going to pay the big man what he owes him, which is information. I gotta say, I gotta go to the bathroom. Hey, you found him. Good work. You helped. Thanks. Guy's still standing in the exact same position looking at his phone. A little bit of subtle humor. So, 9 o'clock, night of the 3rd. What happened in this place? Well, Hamura, he brought that Kume guy in here. Just suddenly. Scared the heck out of me. And then what did the other customers do at that time? Well, there were only three or four of them. So, I mean, when Yakuza come in running and screaming like they did, of course everybody left. I sent the girls who work in the shop, in the club home as well. And after that, the Matsuganegumi people, they beat the heck out of that guy for like an hour. I mean, don't tell anybody you heard that from me. Oh, of course, I won't tell anyone. You're safe. So, it was around 10 o'clock. Something weird happened. Hamura sent everyone home. Even me. I love this cutting in of this footage here. So you left them in there alone, just the two of them. Why did he send everyone out of the shop? He said Kume looked like his, like a friend of his from a long time ago, so they talked. Well, that's weird. Yeah, his buddies thought that was weird as well. But their boss was telling them to go, so they did it. So I don't know what happened after that. Okay, here we go. Oh, yeah. Udaguchi Bohan coming out. Let's ask about the camera out back. What was the fight like in here? What did the police do? We're going to ask these two. What's wrong with the camera out back? Why is the camera out back broken? Again, love the cutting into the footage. I love there's a little editorial to it. It cuts in. How long has it been broken? Since the last month? Maybe some drunk person did something to it. I don't know. So yeah, it hasn't been recording for a while, and it's kind of just decoration. All right, what about the fight in here? Give me a minute, Star. What were you doing during the whole punching? I just shut up and stood there and watched. Though if somebody died in your shop, wouldn't that suck? Didn't you think of reporting it to the police? Reporting it? Of course I'm not going to do that. I don't want to get in trouble by from those Yakuza guys. They weren't actually killing him. They didn't seem like they were actually going to kill him. They were just messing around with him. Having their way, he just got a little bloody nose, that's all, the sort of things. Oh yeah, then detectives came. Kuroiwa. What did you say to him? What did he say? So he just looked around the shop. Wanted to see if there was any blood of the victim in here. Though we'd already cleaned the place up by the time he got there. It looked like he found a little bit of the blood, though he was saying that this was definitely not the scene of the murder. How much blood was there? Before you cleaned it up, I mean. I don't know, a little bit. Not that much, I don't think. So enough for him to say that it wasn't the scene of the murder. I don't know about that, man. That's all I've got. Well, thanks. You helped. That's it? Okay, it's in my case files. I got a lot of more stuff in my case file. What do we got? So we can see everything that he said. Sooner or later, we're going to have to start putting this case together. It's time to leave. My objective is leave the club. And I guess I accomplished that. You know, the only way a tough dude knows how. I have to press a button to answer the phone. I don't want to answer the phone. Is he FaceTiming me? Yeah, I know it's Kaito. I can see you, dude. Where are you, he says. I just left Amur. I'm on Suppondori. Amur? Ketsumochi wa shiteru. Yeah. Yeah, he's telling him that the two of them were alone in here. I love that he's keeping his partner updated on the case with details that he obtained on his own, right? Like, he obtained these details on his own through actions performed by us, the player, and then he keeps his partner updated on them in these little dialogue cutscenes in a way that reminds us of things we've already done. And it's not super subtle, but it serves as something kind of like that you would expect out of a police procedural TV show where they're constantly bringing details back in. He told me, come back to the office. He has something to talk to me about. And he didn't tell me what. And he said, oh, should I come back right now? And he told me, no, it's no hurry. Which leads me to believe that, Wild Jackson buffalo wings? Too hot? Wild Jackson. Too hot. So it leads me to believe that, I'm trying to not bump into anybody. That he's allowing me an opportunity to just chill. So here's what I want to do with my chill time. I want to have a cup of coffee. I want to have a cup of coffee. That's what I want. And that's how I'm going to end this. Total Amusement Tower? Tat? I don't know about all that. Wait, I want to go back to the Cafe Migliore. Where is that? Where's Cafe Migliore? I suppose I must learn my... Oh, here's more sushi. I don't want to go to Yagami Tante Jimsho. Do not want to go to my office just yet. The game is not fully opened up, and it's not letting me go literally anywhere just yet. But, I presume it will soon. Ooh. Octopus. Let's find... Where is that Migliore? I want to go to Migliore. I'm just way off. I don't know what I'm doing. Why you do Jackson? Quadra Garden. Smile Baga. Gyumaru. That's a kitchen. Food, fast food. Gyukak? M-side cafe. Darts? Can I, Okay, where's the, Wait, there's Migliore. It's right there. It's right in front of me. It's right in front of my stupid face. If this were real life, I would be able to find stuff more easily. It's up right there. There it is. Heck oh. It's in this door. If this were real life, my ability to hold landmarks in my mental space would be a little bit stronger. Cafe Migliore. This is the kind of... I'm not kidding. I would chill here in real life. I love how they have this old sign here that has a different sort of layout of the same words. They designed two signs. So some 3D artist doing just the Lord's work makes this sign that goes above the door and then makes a different sign that goes on this little stand for outside. And all for an imaginary coffee shop. In a video game town. All I want is to enjoy a quick cup. I don't have cigarettes, so I want to enjoy a cup. Oh my god, Brendo Kohi, Cappuccino, Espresso, Earl Grey, Omurice, Carbonara, Orange Juice, Iso Lemon Tea, Hershey Salada, Honey Toast. I said Honey Toast earlier. That stuff will make you thirsty. What do they got? Kisetsu Gente Keiki, Vanilla Ice Cream. Oh man, Kin-iro Monblanc, Golden Monblanc. Baked Cheese Cake. Baguette. What? I want espresso. Give it to me. I have to like, I can buy like more than one thing. Should I have an om rice as well? What does it do? Does it actually have a... Should I get an om rice and an espresso? No. Sorry, hold on. I want, well, you can, like, order, like, multiples. I want to just have an espresso. Like a real hard dude. The tougher the dude, the tinier the coffee cup. That is a fact. A real tough dude. Oh, yeah. Give thanks. Oh, my God, you can hear his throat. I need another sip. Take another sip. Oh, there it is. Now I'm going to give you all one. Let's see how I can do. Did you like that? Did you hear that? I'm doing a better job than him. Hold on, a little bit more. Ugh. Mm. Oh yeah, real good. I guess I let this decaf coffee sit here for like 2.5 hours. Well, it's cold and gross, and it got strong and hard, and there's all sorts of little grains and bubbles in the bottom. I got it all over myself. And I don't mean I spilled it. I mean I got it all over the inside of myself. Can I buy some smokes at the convenience store now? Can I smoke a cigarette? Arigatou gozaimashita. Don't talk to me. I got 20 SP points for drinking that espresso. Whenever you get SP points, it's like a different color depending on the thing you did. Oh, sorry. I don't want to bump into everybody. I don't want to be a big jerk. Who bumps into everyone. Is that Popo? Can I get big cigs? I really don't need you. Okay, give me that. Sorry, don't get in the way of a man and his devil sticks. Oh my god. I can buy everything now. I can buy cat food. I can buy a gold pizza man. A pochetto tissue. Jack Daniels? It's real Jack Daniels? What? I didn't know there was real Jack Daniels in here. Mitsuya Saida. Oh my god, I want to drink a Mitsuya cider. A Wanda coffee. This is, oh my god, it's Dodecamine, which is that Asahi brand energy drink. 7 stars. It's a real brand of cigarettes and Asahi beer. Oh my god, I love this. All right, 460 yen. Cigarettes are like $17 in New York, so this is like, this is real, real wish fulfillment. Should I go back to the internet cafe to smoke them? Let's wait. I need to find the internet cafe. Krabu Amur. Oh, these are game centers. VR salon. There's a VR salon. Is that miniature golf? Oh, that's a park. Popo. So I have cigarettes. I have cigarettes. The question is, am I tough enough to smoke them? I have to go to the bathroom in real life. I tell you what, Wait, the internet cafe is right by Mijore, isn't it? The Mantai, as it's called. Drone races, M-side cafe. I need to smoke cigarettes in the internet cafe. Heck, I can't find no internet cafe. Ikinari Steak. Suddenly Steak is the name of that steak restaurant. This is the real experience of Tokyo. Staring at a map, trying to find a thing. Just trying to measure exactly what direction you'll have to walk and when you have to turn. Planning your route by at which landmark to make a 90 degree turn in which direction. Oh wait, that's Mantai. It's right there. Give me that. Okay. I'm going to go back to the internet cafe and smoke in the smoking room. Now, of course, a guy who looks as tough as this guy, and, you know, he used to be a lawyer, but he ain't no cop. Just because a lawyer doesn't mean he's a narc. Oh. I just told somebody else to not get in the way of a man and his big cigs. I need a smoke, like you need a hole in your head. I've changed poses. Now you should be terrified. As yet, I have approximated no appreciation for the subtlety of whatever this battle system has. Oh, yeah. Wow! I've got to say, I haven't done that in real life in a long time. Thrown a bike up into the air and then kicked it down onto somebody, killing them. I haven't actually ever done that in real life. Oh, I can power up my skills now. Yeah, I want to go into Montai and smoke a cigarette. I want to see what smoking does. Again, the world is my theme park, so I'm riding the escalator. I'm just taking baby steps. I'm dipping my toes into the kiddie pool of this game's, no doubt, wildly rich assortment of diversions. We have drunk an espresso, and now we are gonna suck down a devil stick. Here we go. Eat pukusuru. Just give me one suck, is what it says. Eat puku. That sounds gross, but that's... Oh my god, yeah. Not as dramatic as on the title screen. Yeah. Oh, that's good. That's the good stuff. Toshio totte chimpira. Oh, they're talking about how much the shower costs. Majisuka. It's 100 yen higher than it used to be. Oh, these are just some aging chimpiras they're referred to. He scrubbed it out and threw it back in the box. He just... I mean, that right there is the definition of delinquency. Entering the smoking room, having one suck of tobacco, not even closing the goddarn door. I mean, that's... You might as well have just blown it right in that lady's face. You know, a guy in Japan once, standing next to me, waiting for the light to change on the street... He blew some cigarette smoke in my face, and I turned and looked at him, and I took two fingers and I pulled my eyelid down, and I said, "Hey, you missed this red part right here." And he laughed really hard, and I was like, "I'm just messing with you, man." And he was like, "I'm sorry. You're not supposed to smoke on the street in Tokyo. They threaten you with the fines if the cops catch you." And like I said, I may have been a lawyer, but I ain't no cop. And I may not be a cop, but I ain't no narc. So I'm not going to smoke on the street. And I believe that's actually all we have time for today. I'm going to take out my phone and, I'm going to save my game. You know what? I'm just going to save over my previous save. Let's just do it. Oh, that's an autosave. That's an autosave. Yeah, save here. Yes. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and call it. We had a wonderful time. And I might play more of this game for you all. Or I might just keep it all to myself and enjoy the heck out of it all in my dark lonesome. I like this game a lot. I like its tone. I like its flow. I like the way it goes. It's like a Yakuza game with a little bit, you know... I find this protagonist more relatable because he's... You know, like me, he has a dark past and he beats people up all the time, but only out of justice. And also, he's just trying to do the right thing in his life. Can I have that bat, bro? I want that money from that dude. 6,000? Buy a lot of cigs with 1,000. 6,000. I'm gonna have to kill you, bro. Oh, I was born stupid, however, I will not die hungry. Video games forever. Kotaku.com. Look at his long wallet sticking out of his pocket on a chain. I used to have a long wallet like that. It's very easy to remove from your pocket. Which I guess is the nice thing about having a long wallet. Also, everybody can see how cool your wallet is. And the chain is so they can't steal it easily. In other words, it looks flashy, though it's practical. He made a practical decision when he bought a long wallet. And he made an even more practical decision when he put a chain on it. Though maybe at first glance it looks like he's just stuck in 2007. I should probably stop recording now.